time the players of both teams take a knee before kickoff here. And there's the whistle, and the game begins. Wales in the red shirts, white shorts and red socks, and England in their first choice colours as well, the white shirts with the blue trim on the shoulders, the dark blue shorts and the white socks. So it is Wales against England. This is Five Live and BBC Sounds, of course. The match is live on BBC television tonight. It's on BBC One if you're on your way home. Don't miss it. Guy Mowbray, Jermaine Genus and Danny Gabardon with the commentary there. But if you would like to watch it with Five Live's radio commentary synced up to the pictures, then go to the BBC iPlayer and look for World Cup Extra. So Wales with a throw-in inside their own half. Be interesting to see, as we've discussed, what sort of a start to this game is it? Is it going to be harem scarem from the off? It is England in possession. Kane playing it back and misplaces the pass. A huge cheer for that from the red wall. That's gone down well. Matt Upson, Micah Richards with us here in the commentary position, and Jane Ludlow, former Welsh international, former Welsh manager, is with us as well from back in the studio. Matt.
Yeah, I think it has been that kind of start. It's a little bit scrappy, isn't it? Just that pass from Harry Kane there would indicate that the tensions are a little bit high, and I think it's going to be a little bit back territory in these opening stages. Neither team going to get their foot on the ball properly, and Wales had a clear intention from kickoff, which was to go long for Kiefer Moore, straight back to Ben Davies, long ball into Moore, try and pick up those knockdowns and play from there.
Nice from Stones, taking the ball out from the back after controlling it. And yes, Gareth Bale on the right-hand side and James on the left-hand side. And it is England in possession on the left-hand side. In the first half, Wales are playing from left to right as we look. Jude Bellingham then strokes the ball into centre field. And I think after the most recent performances for England, of course, in the 0-0 draw against the United States, and for Wales in what turned out to be a deeply disappointing match against Iran, the reaction, and just to see what sort of performance the two teams are able to put here in here tonight. Shaw gets the ball back way down below, so here on the left hand side, and then goes back into his own half to Harry Maguire, named as the man of the match against the United States.
It's interesting, John, to see how high Aaron Ramsey is at the moment. He's really pressing high, sitting almost in front of Declan Rice, trying to push up behind Kiefer Moore from that midfield area. I think he's going to play that role of linking between the back four or the midfield and Kiefer Moore, and also try and pressure England a little bit.
0-0, very early stages. England with it on the right-hand side. Incidentally, Iran USA is on television on BBC Two right now. Here is Rice playing the ball to the left-hand side to Shaw. Rashford is outside him on the touchline. This is only the second match that Rashford has started at a World Cup or a European Championship, and a run from him up to the edge of the penalty area, but ran into red shirts and lost possession, and Wales were able to clear. England back in possession though. Shaw back into his own half, and then back to Harry Maguire, and England have it inside their own territory. So Maguire's pass deflected forward off Ramsey and bounces down for Rashford, quickly onto it to play it back into his own half. So there was the clamour for Foden. He started wide on the right-hand side, and Rashford here on the left-hand side. So Phil Foden starting a match at a World Cup for the first time. Just one substitute appearance so far at this tournament, in the first group match when he came on as a substitute in the 71st minute in the rout of Iran. Maguire just to his right to Stones. This is rather like the opening stages of the USA game. England keeping possession inside their own half. Rice then goes back to Maguire. And very patient from England. And now Pickford will get a touch as well as it's played across to him. Just passes it out short. Kyle Walker, his first involvement. Kyle Walker at this tournament. First time he's played since the Manchester derby, having now recovered from that groin injury. So no Kieran Trippier tonight. And England still knocking it around in their own half, Matt.
It's been nice to see us move it with a little bit more purpose. I know that sometimes it's calming the game, but I think being a bit more progressive with our passing, moving the ball quicker around the back, especially with Harry Maguire, who's holding onto the ball for quite a long time. I'd rather kind of lend the ball, get it back, and then the picture changes and you can maybe find that pass.
Just as you spoke, Matt, Maguire went for a long pass down the left-hand side that Rashford, with his heels on the white line, couldn't keep the ball in play, and it is a throw-in to Wales. Let's bring in an early thought from Jane Ludlow back in the studio. Jane.
Well, look, it's what we thought. It's a lower block from us. You know, we're defending the halfway line back. At times it looks like a 4-4-2, but it's actually a 4-4-1-1 defensive shape. And you've got Aaron Ramsey predominantly defensively on the pitch there to deal with Declan Rice today. And even in the first few minutes, you can see England will generally play with like a single pivot. So Declan Rice, dropping off, looking for the ball from the back line. But it'll be interesting to see if they end up doing two deeper line midfielders, how we cope with that. Because right now, Aaron Ramsey is on that pitch to defend Declan Rice. And that looks like 99% of his job tonight.
Thank you, Jane. Wales 0, England 0. England thought they were away there, but referee Vincic brought it back for a foul centre field by Jordan Henderson. So Wales played back to Danny Ward. And great form for Leicester for the resurgent Leicester City. Played every minute at the Euro, so has tournament experience. But this is his first time starting at the World Cup, Danny Ward. Here now is Bellingham on the left-hand side, over the halfway line to Rashford, who just passes it back to Declan Rice, who's managed to find a little bit of space away from Aaron Ramsey. Now the Liverpool captain, Jordan Henderson, out to the right-hand side. I thought he settled things down, Henderson, against the United States when he came on as a substitute. He's playing at his third World Cup, Jordan Henderson. Now to the left-hand side.
Yeah, I don't think it was a surprise to see him in the starting lineup today, was it, for a game like this, which is going to require that kind of more experienced head, maybe, in moments of just handling the game and the occasion.
Yes, likewise, similar thought. I think we knew that he was going to play from the moment that he was put up to speak to the media in the FIFA conference yesterday, Jordan Henderson. Ramsey is bundled over, 5 or 6 yards inside his own half, 6 minutes on the clock. Wales 0, England 0, still Iran 0, USA 0. And now back it goes into centre field to Joe Rodon. Now out to the left-hand side where James can't keep it in. It's a throw-in to England just inside the Welsh half. Joe Rodon, who is currently on loan in France with Rennes, but from Tottenham. And there are actually 11 different British clubs represented by the 22 that are starting this match. England with Foden trying to take it on, but wasn't able to get the ball under control. And it's through the middle to Kiefer Moore. And now forward from Bale, but he's put far too much on that pass, Gareth Bale, in the centre circle, and it was weird. It was right between, it bisected the two Welsh players, and out for a throw.
Yeah, Kiefer Moore had just dragged in both centre halves, had gone short for the ball and laid it off, and there was a big space in behind Kyle Walker, and it was a poor pass over. I don't think they had any real runners into that area either, but I'm just still waiting for England to really show a bit of confidence with the ball and get a few passes together, a few combinations in the Wales half, really. They've had the ball in and around their own halfway line, but nothing of note yet getting forwards into the wide players. I don't think Foden's really seen the ball.
So Wales have got it in the centre circle, and it's played back into central defence. Meppen passes it out down here to Nico Williams, who's switched over to the right-hand side, playing as right back in this formation. Nico Williams now with Nottingham Forest. Ball from centre field from Ampadu, but that evades Dan James on the far side as well. Didn't give him a chance really, and it's out of play for a throw-in to England. Yeah, neither team really has settled in.
No, not at all. And just that kind of epitomizes it there for me. I think Dan James needs to almost stay wide. You'd rather him have his heels on the touchline and wait for that ball to get to him, and then he's coming onto that pass and driving at a defender. But you're right, John, it's pretty much a scrappy start, isn't it? No real quality of any passes put together and control possession.
England bringing the ball out from the back. That's Matt Upson with us, played at the World Cup for England, scored at the World Cup for England. And it's currently 0-0 here in what is the 104th match between these sides. The first one back in 1879, 143 years ago, was played at the Oval with the pitch covered in snow. And I know this is a Winter World Cup, but Kane playing it through for Rashford through the middle. Ward comes out and makes a good stop at his feet. Came out quickly there, Danny Ward, and really England opened up the Welsh defence there. One pass from Kane through the middle, Rashford running onto it. We spoke before the match about how they could work together, and that was to great effect, and Wales were saved by Danny Ward.
Out of nothing, great anticipation from Declan Rice, steps in and just wins that ball in the midfield. It was bobbling about into Kane, and what I loved is that as soon as Rashford saw Declan Rice win that ball, his reaction to make that run in behind in the most hurtful place he could of the Welsh back four, and Harry Kane has the vision to try and slide him in. Decent pass, actually, just couldn't lift it over the keeper, Marcus Rashford, but good opportunity for England.
Ward saved England, Jane Ludlow, but that was worrying.
Yeah, it was, and look, we're banking up with two banks of four right now, fairly compact units, but as soon as England move the ball right to left a couple of times and switch play, there's gaps opening up in our midfield, which has nearly happened there again, straight through central areas, and it is a bit of a worry for us.
England win it back. Walker gives it to his clubmate Foden. Now back to Walker on the right-hand side, and he angles it back to Henderson, and Henderson's ball across the penalty area is cleared away by Nico Williams at the back post. Nico Williams being found by Jordan Henderson, his former clubmate. Wales 0, England 0. Let's see how things have started between Iran and the USA. Conor McNamara.
0-0. We've just had the first attempted goal from Yunus Musa, the United States number 6, whose birthday it is today. He was slightly leaning back. He drilled it over the top. As things stand, England and Iran going through. It's Iran 0, USA at the moment, 0.
Yep, it's as you were. England 4 points, Iran 3 points, USA 2 points, Wales 1 point coming into tonight. Rice playing it square to Stones. And now Kyle Walker on the right-hand side, and then back into his own half. And England, I think, will go not quite all the way back to Pickford. Stones is going to keep possession. So the group winners tonight will play Senegal in the last 16. We know that now after the earlier matches. And the runners-up will play Louis van Gaal and the Netherlands. Wales 0, England 0. Wyatt goes for a long, long crossfield pass looking for Walker, but it's volleyed away by Ben Davis. And then England take up possession again inside the long half.
England have settled a little bit after that chance, I think. Maybe if it was just a little shock for Wales, just to realise that it can happen very quickly, and they're just holding their position more than pressing in. And England, having comfortable possession of the ball in their own half, just need to create those spaces and just get their key players on the ball.
Long pass from Pickford from just to the left of the penalty area, looking for Kane, but that's dealt with by Rodon. And so Wales have got it back again. Joe Allen, who's starting the match for the first time since mid-September. Long pass forward from Williams, but that's way beyond the run of Gareth Bale. Pickford's able to underarm it out to John Stones. Now to Walker on the right-hand side, but he just goes back to Pickford. Well, we wonder whether it might be a gung-ho start. It's not.
No, it's not a gung-ho start. It started a bit scrappy, didn't it? As you'd expect. Neither team really settled in the first 5 minutes. A lot of loose balls. The ball's bobbling around in midfield, going out for throw-ins, but the game's finally settled. Like I said, I think that chance for Marcus Rashford has just sent a little message of how quickly the game could turn. And maybe it just causes a little bit of caution sometimes, and it's just settled.
Walker's pass, a long pass from right to left this time. Chested down by Shaw. Might have been a handball by Nico Williams. It was, says the referee. That's a free kick in a decent position on the left wing.
It is. I mean, I think he tucks his arm behind his back, Nico Williams, just to try and stop that pass. It just clips his hand. I think it's just a reaction from him. But it's a nice position. You look at the threat that Harry Maguire was, especially in the first game, from any kind of crosses or set pieces. He's certainly a player that England need to look at.
Shaw and Rashford are together here on the left-hand side. The two of the Manchester United men just looking at each other, having a little word. And then Rashford looks down. Shaw looks into the centre. Wales holding their line about a yard inside the penalty area. Harry Kane closest to the penalty spot. Shaw waiting to take this, left foot in front of right. There's the whistle from the referee, and it will be Luke Shaw with the free kick, played in towards the back post looking for Maguire, but that's headed away. It comes out to Foden, takes it down and shoots from the angle, but drags it wide through a number of players inside the box. But goal kick, 0-0.
Yeah, I think he just tries to hit that through the bodies there. Phil Foden picks up a good position, identifying that the ball's going to get cleared. And he tries to hit that near post through the legs of a couple of Welsh players just to see what happens, really. But he just doesn't execute it. Not a clean strike, just drags the ball well wide of that near post.
Good noise inside the stadium for Wales, England. The red wall, they stand out so clearly behind that goal that Danny Ward is protecting to our left. And the England fans all around the lower tier at the other end with so many England flags. Ward, oh, that's a poor goal kick by Ward. He's got that all wrong. And he immediately apologises. Just scuffed it straight out of play on the halfway line.
I think he's even chuckling to himself, to be honest. It was that far off, wasn't it?
But he's got some credit in the bank, Matt, already.
That was
a decent stop, wasn't
it? No, he comes out
Rashford.
Quickly. He comes out quickly. Marcus Rashford tries to lift the ball over him, but he was off the line and saw the danger and came out. It was a good block.
Yeah, in form. 5 clean sheets in his last 6 Premier League appearances. England with the ball on the right-hand side. Gordon trying to find Henderson, but across comes Davis and puts it out of play. And it's a throw-in for England. Away over there in that far corner. It's going to be left to Kyle Walker to take this. England with Foden and Henderson in the full-back position, and it is Foden that's used, and now he's trying to find a way into the penalty area between a couple of Wales players, but it's played back to Henderson, and now back to Walker, and Walker sort of scoops it infield with his right foot, and Rice plays it back to the halfway line. Still goalless. First 15 minutes have now been played. One big chance when Kane slipped through Rashford through the middle, and Ward came out to make the save. Still 0-0 in the other match. Maguire just knocks it to his right, to Stones. And there's not too much movement in front of John Stones. So just takes another touch and gives it back to Maguire. This is all very static, I must say.
Masses of possession at the moment, though, for England, isn't it? Like you say, it's a little bit in their own half and not particularly threatening, but Wales just need to get hold of the ball.
Up to the edge of the area to Kane, then clear. And then Kane, that was heavy. The challenge from behind on him by Meppham. Kane went down, felt the contact, gets a free kick, left of centre, 25 yards out.
This is a nice distance, and he's got a nice bit of angle on this free kick. It's left of centre, probably between the penalty spot and the edge of the 18-yard box, but like you say, about 10 yards out, it's almost ideal for that dipping free kick, that if you can get it up and down over the wall, could cause a real problem to Ward.
So there are 4 England players around this free kick. Rashford is behind it, Foden's there as well, Henderson, Rice, and
it's
actually
it's
now
a conference.
5. Yeah, that's half the team. Rashford wanders away, so it won't be him. He looks slightly hangdog as he does so. Maybe he did fancy having a go, and he's having a chat with John Stones now on the edge of the wall. So Declan Rice, Shaw, and actually Stones and Rashford are now walking back to Henderson.
They're thinking, where's Trippier? Why is he not here?
On the bench. And Stones and Rashford then walk back into position, and Henderson's lining them up.
I'm not sure it's going to be a shot here. I think it could be a left-footed Luke Shaw to the back post for Harry Maguire. If you look at the matchup at the back post, whether or not that's going to get floated to that back post area.
We've got everything but a whiteboard for this one. Henderson and Wright and Foden are standing in front of the ball. Shaw behind it. Right, it's tapped to Rice, then Shaw curls it into the back post. Maguire's there to head it across, but he heads it into the side netting. Now he's claiming that it took a touch off a defender, but the assistant on the far side is indicating that it was a goal kick. So Wales 0, England 0, 5 Live and BBC Sounds here in Doha at the World Cup. And Jane Ludlow is watching from, a little further away, Jane.
Yeah, just a little bit further away, Manchester. But look, I was expecting a bit more then, guys, to be fair. That setup of the set play, I was expecting something unusual. And look, thankfully for the Welsh team that, you know, we've ended up clearing it fairly easy at the end of it. But we're living a little bit dangerously. Look, England have so much possession, I guess. As long as there's that clean sheet for us, we've still got a chance. And that's how I'm looking at this game right now, because we can't get hold of the ball at the moment.
No, Wales must win, or they're going home after this. And they also need Iran and USA to draw. So they're doing their bit. Iran 0, USA 0. And Stones putting the ball out of play for a throw, but Wales have been forced back into their own half, and actually struggling to keep that in. Was Ben Davis, who stretched and played it back to Ward, who was put under pressure, so his clearance is onto the head of Shaw, and now Bellingham was very nearly in there, but he was beaten to it by Meppham. Currently England with 75% possession, and England with it again halfway inside their own half. So Wales 0, England 0, and Conor McNamara watching the other match.
It is still Iran 0, USA 0. It's been all USA so far. The best attempt on target, a header from Christian Pulisic that was saved. Iran can still top the group. Even a draw might be enough to see them through. But for USA, only a win is going to be enough for them. 0-0 for the moment.
And just to repeat, it is possible that England and Wales could both go through tonight. 20 minutes played. Wales 0, England 0. And Stones and Maguire again, who they must be topping the passing statistics at the moment. Stones and Maguire, we've seen them constantly knock the ball to one another. Pickford will hit this long, and he will hit it onto the head of Mepham, who heads it forward. Then Joe Allen nods it on, but it's headed forward for England by Stones. Rashford gambled there. It was just cleared away near the edge of the penalty area. Walker misses his kick against keeper Moore, who puts in the challenge, sends Walker sprawling, and it's England's ball.
It's a little bit of indecision there, wasn't there, between Kyle Walker and John Stones. The ball bounced between them. It was kind of like equal distance, and neither one really took control of the situation. Then Kyle Walker had to have a little acceleration to deal with the ball. Gets there first, and Kiefer Moore goes to ground and makes the foul. But you're absolutely right, John, in terms of where England are having a lot of the ball between the two centre-backs. It's not where you want the ball. You need to be a bit more progressive. And I know it can be difficult if Wales are going to drop off and sit and try and make life difficult to break them down. You've got to try and find a different way, whether or not that is into the front a little bit more and just getting Harry Kane more involved with little balls clipped over the top or put into his feet.
Rashford to Rice, and then Rice up towards Foden, who lays it off instantly to the right-hand side to Walker. Walker uses Henderson. He takes a couple of touches, then back to the right-hand side. And Kyle Walker winning his 71st cap tonight. And it's all the way back to Maguire. Touch from Rice. Now taking it out to the left-hand side, Shaw. And then Rice again, who's on the left wing, plays it infield. A touch from Rashford back to Shaw, who gets it onto his left foot and then swings the ball in. Henderson, but it bounced awkwardly and bounced up. Took a touch off his head. He did well in the end to keep it in on the far side. Walker infield. Rice is there. He's got some space. He takes it out to the right-hand side and then slips it to the right. And Henderson's ball across is played away in the middle by Mepham and out for a throw down the right. And England there were stretching Wales, finding spaces.
Yeah, I'm surprised Harry Kane didn't really react the moment that ball got played back into Henderson. He didn't make that run across the defender. He almost just stayed on his heels around the penalty spot, and it was easily dealt with. But it was a good position Jordan Henderson was in. He'd really got to that byline and he had the free rein just to pick someone out in the 18-yard box.
And then Henderson is fouled on the far side near the corner flag by Ben Davis. So it's a free kick to England just about 8 or 10 yards back from the corner flag on the right-hand side. Not too far away from all of those red shirts with the Welsh dragon on them. And free kick to be played in. So up comes Maguire again. Harry Kane takes up a position at the back post. Declan Rice and Bellingham near the penalty spot. So Wales bringing Kiefer Moore back in there as well at the far side of the penalty area near the near post as we look. So the free kick is played in by Henderson. Maguire couldn't reach it. And now Rashford has to keep it in, which he does on the left-hand side. And Rashford will take on Joe Allen and shoot goalwards, and that is headed away by Nico Williams, who took that right on the forehead with his knees bent, and it's actually knocked him over backwards, and the referees immediately stopped play.
Well, the best place to take that ball is on the forehead at that speed. If when it hits you on the top of the head, that's when you start to get a little bit starry-eyed. But he
I think he did.
I think he just dipped his head down, didn't he? So if it catches you on the forehead, you kind of hardened to deal with that a lot better than when it's on the top. And that's why he kind of reeled backwards once the ball had hit him. It really was travelling for Marcus Rashford. It was a long-range shot, hit him straight in the head, full on.
Well, he's going to need a little bit of treatment here. So we have played a quarter of the match now. The first quarter is over. Just the one chance, really, I would say. One direct chance, the opportunity that Rashford had through the middle. Let's see what Jane Ludlow, former Wales manager, has made of that first quarter.
Well, look, positives for Wales are that it's still 0-0. There's been a huge amount of possession for England and had a couple of chances in and around the box, but nothing, obviously, apart from the great chance early on, which Danny Ward did very well to save. So in that sense, I think Wales are doing pretty well. You know, a quarter of the match in and 0-0, it's a good start for us. But ideally, we'd like a little bit more of the ball to actually threaten England when we actually do have the ball and retain the ball better.
Thank you, Jane. So far, we've seen almost nothing from Gareth Bale.
No, it's represented in the stats. I mean, it's interesting how they have the stats on the little screen here, isn't it? Because you get the ball in contest for a percentage, so it can be a bit misleading. But I'm looking at Wales's possession stats, and what is that, John? 19% of the game so far. It's very difficult to score a goal when you have the ball that little. And like you said, Wales need that goal. They need to win this game. So by somehow, they have to get hold of the ball.
We also have Juliet Farrington, who's down pitch side behind the goal at the England end. Juliet?
We've just had a rendition of the national anthem from the England fans behind me. I've got to say, it's gone a little bit flat. I think that just reflects the performance so far that we're seeing, you know, an England controlling possession, as you say, but it's been fairly conservative so far. Chesney Hawkes, though, does seem to be enjoying it on my left. He's going to be performing at half-time, as we know.
Yes.
Mike will be delighted.
Well, Mark Chapman's very much looking forward to that, and Micah, maybe less so.
He's just looking so excited. He's sitting to my right.
Has he come round to it? Here's Maguire carrying the ball forward, Shaw to Rashford on the left-hand side. Here comes the challenge, two Welsh players on him, and it is brought away and taken away by Nico Williams, who is back on the field after being checked out and checked over. He's okay, but keeper Moore can't keep the ball in, and it's a throw into England, almost right on the halfway line. So 0-0. Get another update on Iran-USA. In fact, let's do that now as the ball is blocked out for another England throw. Connor.
26 minutes played, Iran 0, USA 0. Iran have had their first attack of the game. Taremi into the penalty area. I was surprised he didn't take it on himself. He was unselfish. He tried to lay it back for Osmoun, but the USA got too many defenders back there. There's only been the one shot on target from the game from Pulisic. It's Iran 0, USA 0.
So it is currently England going through as group winners and Iran as runners-up, as the table was at the start of play. England play the ball down the right wing, and a foul on Ben Davis, and it is a free kick to Wales down there. Just a great deal of contact from Phil Foden, but enough to draw the foul and a free kick. So what do you reckon, Matt, from a Welsh point of view so far, and is this better from England?
Not yet for me. I don't think it's better. We haven't got into a rhythm. We've had a lot of possession, but that's mainly due to the fact that Wales haven't been able to keep the ball. And then once we have the ball, they're kind of sitting in their shape. So we're able to control large parts of the game, but in and around our own half or on the halfway line. But I haven't seen us really click yet or connect anything like the first game in terms of combinations of movement and passing. We haven't really opened Wales up, other than that chance which came from a turnover. Brilliant piece of anticipation from Declan Rice, who won the ball in the attacking half. So, yeah, I think England, you know, a lot to improve on in terms of having possession and being a threat with the ball.
Maguire putting it out of play, clearing it from near the edge of the penalty area. Still Wales 0, England 0, 5 live, BBC Sound. Now here's Kiefer Moore. Kiefer Moore against Rice, 25 yards from the England goal. Surrounded by England players, Bellingham got the important touch. It's played up into the centre circle. And then Kane is able to latch onto the loose ball after Bellingham was challenged. But plays it forward, gives it back to Wales, and Williams is now bringing it forward, and he's leaned into and fouled by Jordan Henderson, as I say, his old captain, who then almost lands on top of him, gives him a pat on the backside, and that isn't going to get him off a kicking off from referee Vincic.
Oh, it was clumsy from Jordan Henderson. He was never going to get the right side of Nico Williams. I mean, Harry Kane has got to try and release that ball a little bit earlier a moment ago. It was a great tackle from Aaron Ramsey recovering into that area of the pitch. But the foul from Jordan Henderson puts him in a little bit of position now, doesn't it? He's got to be careful.
Yep.
It's good to see a couple of tackles, though, John.
Well, Dan James has caught John Stones with a late one there, actually.
It's good to see a bit of tackling going. It's been a little bit flat, hasn't it, in terms of incident and... You know, if you're not going to have too much quality with the ball in the opening stages, you want to see a bit of that fire and the tackles going in, and we're starting to see that a little bit more in the game.
And there we are, the first yellow card, Dan James. It was late. It was late.
It was.
Johnston.
It was. And I think it was like you say, the third tackle in the space of a minute or two, and the referee has got the yellow card out.
So almost half an hour played. Not a very good game, must be said. It's not a thriller by any means. It's a little bit like the games I used to watch when I was growing up between Wales and England, many of them, in the home nations championship, when very often people forget, you know, very often you hear people saying, oh, wouldn't it be great to bring back the home internationals? Actually, many of them were rubbish. Here's Stones.
Sure we could crowbar a couple into the schedule. Yes. There's not enough games going on.
Not enough. They get off lightly, these players. Bulls played by Stones out towards the far side. Kept in and then worked back out to the left-hand side. James is there, Walker's with him, shoulder to shoulder. And then Bellingham takes over. Not seen too much of Jude Bellingham yet in this match. 20th cap tonight. The youngest man to win 20 caps for England since Wayne Rooney.
It's a different role for him, isn't it? He's just playing a little bit higher up the pitch. He's got Declan Rice and Henderson operating in that area where he normally likes to be, and then making those surging runs from a bit deeper. At the moment, he's just picked the ball up in like a number 10 position with his back to goal. It's a different requirement for him.
That was better. I was watching him because you were talking about him and he called for it, got it. England still with it on the right-hand side. Here is Foden, turns. He's full of energy, Foden. Then back to Walker, back to Rice, 30 yards out. Challenge comes in from Kiefer Moore, but back to Henderson on the right-hand side. Foden and Henderson there together. Henderson receives it. Now back to Rice, black hair bobbing as he does so, across to Harry Maguire, who's going to have a little wander forward. And he does towards the corner of the penalty area. He's now into the box and he drives it across. I think he was going for goal and he mishit it. And it's actually out for a throw-in.
I thought it looked like a deflection from Harry Maguire there when he hit this ball. You know, he does those drives forward, which I quite like. You know, he carries the ball really well and he gets it onto his left foot. Maybe he should just pop it wide at that point and allow whoever's out there just to try and cross the ball. But he tries to just almost fire it across the goal. I don't think it was a shot, but he goes out for a throw-in on the far side.
Yeah, that won't be... I won't need to get the pen out for that one either. So just the one note that I've made, the Rashford chance early on in the game. Henderson hooking it over the top. That's way beyond anyone in a white shirt. And Wales have got it at the back. Let's bring in Jane Ludlow again.
Well, it's not a game that keeps you on the edge of your seat right now, guys, is it? But look, from a Welsh perspective, it's great. It's 0-0 still. It keeps the team in with a chance. From an England perspective, quality could be better in the final third. But Wales fans would be happy that it's not right now.
No, I don't think at the moment, if Netherlands and Senegal, after winning the group and finishing runners-up and knowing that they'll play the teams from this section, they're not going to be quaking in their boots watching this, are they?
I think Jane's spot on. It's not the most riveting game I've ever seen, and neither team, England as well, are not playing particularly well in terms of looking at a threat or looking any kind of danger with the ball. And there's a lot of possession. And I keep saying, I know Wales are trying to make life difficult, sitting in there, not allowing too much space, but England have to do more. We have to have more movement off the ball and interchanging position and try and run in behind or be more direct, whatever it needs. It needs something a bit different.
But remember, England's objective here, their first objective at this World Cup, was to finish top of this group. So let's see where things are at the end of the night. Here's Rice, back to Foden. Foden. And to Rice again, little ball through to Henderson. Rice once more, England keeping possession, moving it forward. Walker with the cross, that's headed away. It was right onto the head of Meppham, who was able to head it out over on the far side. A throw to England, halfway inside the half, and Nico Williams has sat down now on the edge of the area. I didn't see him receiving a knock. The referee is pointing to his head. Yeah. And it looks as though he is dazed after being hit. I think it was on the top of the head by the shot from, was it Rashford?
It was Rashford, yeah. And on his right foot.
And he's not, it looks as though he is struggling, whether there's a bit of double vision, what it is. He sat down, he's talking to the two medical men from Wales, and they're chatting, and they're giving him a slurp of water. So it's another chance for the players to come across and receive the water bottles. See, Luke Shaw is down there, Gareth Southgate just wandering forward to have a little word with him. Rob Page, likewise, is actually chatting with his coaching staff, and we will have another stoppage here. So it looks as though Conor Roberts is going to be prepared to come on. So that is going to be it for Nico Williams, who has moved across the players, the right back and this back four. And Conor Roberts, the number 14, the Burnley man, top of the championship, is going to come on to replace him. So Wales 0, England 0, 10 minutes to go to half-time. And what's happening in the Iran-USA game. Conor McNamara.
Still Iran 0, USA 0. Still the USA on top. They've had more passes in the final third tonight than in either of the games against Wales or England. And they've just had a big opportunity. Tim Weah, who scored against Wales, just on the edge of the penalty area. Two defenders in front of him. And he absolutely went for power rather than accuracy. He blazed it over the top. But a good chance. Iran 0, USA 0. As things stand, USA would be going out and Iran going through with England.
Five Live from the BBC. This was a night, the final night in Group B at this World Cup, where you thought there could be all sorts of swings and exciting possibilities. And at the moment, there's not been a goal in either match, and it's all been rather dull. So Williams is still, he's on his feet now.
Keep selling it, John.
You have to speak truth to the three people of the world.
No, I completely agree. I mean, you're kind of sitting here thinking, well, let's try and delve into what's going on. How are England playing? What's Wales' approach, given the fact that they have to win this game? And yeah, the game isn't speaking that, is it?
No, it certainly is not. Put very well. So Williams, Nico Williams, is being loudly applauded off the field. That's a really disappointing way, isn't it? And a sad way for his, potentially, his World Cup to come to an end. Jane Ludlow.
Yeah, it's not a great way for the World Cup to end for the guy, is it? But do you know, the thing I'm most surprised about with regards to Wales' setup so far in this game is we're working really hard to win the ball back. But when we win the ball back, you're expecting a quick transition, play longer, earlier. But Wales are actually looking to retain. Now, whether that's the game plan, I'd be surprised if that is the game plan.
Long throw for England into the Welsh penalty area, but that's adjudged to have been a foul. And Wales win the free kick. And just a challenge by, well, Maguire and Stones were both in there, and Maguire is penalised.
I didn't see too much in that, John. Whether or not, I think it might have been a shove from Stones initially, as Kiefer Moore actually just goes clattering into Meppham, I think it is. Whether or not it was just a bit of contact from Stones that sent him on his way.
So Conor Roberts is on for what is his 44th cap tonight. And Wales, this is a rare foray forward from Wales. Ramsey near the edge of the box, back to Kiefer Moore. Rice put the challenge in. Thought he fouled him.
I did.
Thought he fouled, yeah, Kiefer Moore, and that's not given us a free kick. And England are quickly away on the move. White shirts pouring forward, down the flanks and in the middle. And here's a flick from Bellingham. Nice. And then a back heel by Walker, and Bellingham in the area, and Foden on the turn. Left foot shot flies wide and high beyond the far top left corner. But that was better, much better from England.
Absolutely, first little flurry from England to get excited about. It's that man Jude Bellingham showing the skills and the flicks and the twirls. Really does swivel so well on the ball. It's a cheeky little back heel just to find Foden in the opposing box, but it just had a bit of flow to it, John, didn't it? The ball turned over, England broke forwards, and all of a sudden you've got three or four white shirts in support, making runs, high energy. It's what we want to see more of.
But Wales had a really good case for a free kick for Kiefer Moore, which would have been in Gareth Bale territory.
I thought he'd lost the ball, John, but I thought Declan Rice just prodded his leg out and made contact with him.
This is Bale now into the action, could get completely past Harry Maguire. But still Wales in possession, Ampadu. Now Ramsey, just outside the area, gives it squared. Allen, whose shot is blocked down by Rice, and England could be off on the counter-attack again here. Rashford in possession, running from deep inside his own half, down the left wing. Conor Roberts just under the field. He's passed him. Gives it back to Rice, though. And Rice could have gone for the pass out to the right-hand side. Henderson took a little moment there to give it to Walker, and Wales are now back in position. It's Foden on the right-hand side. Foden low ball into the box. That's cleared. Henderson swirls it in, takes the deflection. Rashford with the overhead kick. That would have been truly spectacular from 13, 14 yards out. But with the bicycle kick, he pulled it wide of the left post by 3 or 4 yards. So it's 0-0 here in the Ahmed Bin Ali Stadium. But there has been a goal in the Iran-USA match. Conor McNamara.
Yes, developments in the game, developments in the group, because the USA have taken the lead. Iran 0, USA 1. Christian Pulisic finishing from close range after Dest's header back along the edge of the six-yard box. Pulisic injured himself colliding with the goalkeeper, but the ball into the back of the net. We've seen the replays. There's no offside flags, and this will mean that the USA will be moving up the standings. As things stand, they go to second in Group B behind England, and Iran would be going out if it remains like this. The opening goal of the night in this group, Iran 0, USA 1.
And here's Foden for England. Foden taking it on, riding the challenges, giving it to Kane. Now to Rashford. Rashford's ball across is blocked behind for a corner, and that again threatened to open up for England. Conor Roberts blocked it behind. Corner, yeah, from the left.
Yeah, it's not like intentional build-up, but what I like about it, it's got real purpose when England are going forward. Phil Foden then skips past the tackle, the ball bobbles on, does really well to maintain it, feeds it to Kane, it comes out wide to Rashford. I just don't think he quite selects the right pass. He tries to square the ball, and I think the ball right across the face with his left foot in front of all the England players. You had Foden just really making his way into that six-yard box for a tap-in.
0-0 on Five Live. First match between two of our home nations at a World Cup. Not too much to get excited about so far, but
it's getting there, John.
Yeah, better signs of promise in the last few minutes. Foden takes the corner in. It's headed to the edge of the area, and then Henderson lifts it over the top. Rashford's trying to get there. It bounces behind. It was off the head of Ben Davis, and it is a corner to England from the right-hand side.
He's got to keep applying pressure. Good quality delivery into the box. We need to make more of these set plays. He's been a major asset for England in the past, especially in Russia. You have the ability to be effective.
Foden to take it from that far side, left-footed into the near post, and it's headed up and away and back out towards that side by Joe Rodon. So it's out for a throw to England. In fact, in the last sort of 5 minutes or so, Wales have offered more in the game.
Yeah.
And as a result of that, England have had the opportunity to counter-attack, and that's made it a better game.
Exactly. I think England might prefer if Wales do come out and have a bit more of the ball and push men forward as they have to. I think that's going to play into England's hands, to be honest, because the counter-attack that we have can be really good.
Yeah, and let's not forget, Wales have to win this game. They've got a standard chance of going through. They need the other match to be a draw. It's not. USA are winning. So at the moment, England would finish top of the group and the United States in second. Half-time approaching. Shaw for England. Back into his own half to Harry Maguire. Now passing 50 caps. His 51st tonight across to John Stones. His 62nd. And Stones just giving it back again to Harry Maguire. What we've got as well with Walker coming in, we've gone back for England to this half Manchester City, half Manchester United back four. Walker and Stones and Maguire and Shaw.
We've also got Walker just coming inside the pitch as well, which is very Manchester City-like from that full-back position to try and allow Phil Foden to get hold of the ball.
Maguire for Foden on the stretch, a long pass, which was asking an awful lot of Phil Foden. He went for it, he saw it, but he got a foot to it, yeah, but couldn't keep it in.
It was always just drifting the wrong way, wasn't it? Nice idea from Harry Maguire just to try and switch that play and stretch Wales a little bit, and Phil Foden just couldn't get there.
What are you thinking, Jane Ludlow?
I'm thinking the game's playing out as we probably would have thought. You know, for Wales, it's about getting through the first 45, trying to keep clean sheet, get in 0-0 and throw everything at it the second half, because Wales are going to have to change something second half, aren't they?
Here's Kane in the centre circle, but surrounded by red shirts. He's been fouled by one of them. The red wall didn't like that. Dan James, it was, who just ran into Kane, blocked him. So free kick to England. Juliet Farrington takes side. What can you see?
Well, I can see that Wales look like they are going to make a substitution before half-time. I can see one of their players getting ready in the distance. They're obviously further away from me than the England bench is, but look out for that one. And just to say on Nico Williams as well, that substitution, he came off, that was a concussion change, that substitution when Williams came off, and he went straight down the tunnel with a member of the Wales medical team.
Yep, so Wales would have that extra chance. Rashford now to the edge of the area, pulled it back. Shaw, Rice, he gives it to his left. Rashford in the box, lots of red shirts to beat. Plays it slightly behind both Bellingham and Shaw, but Bellingham has done well. And Roberts is able to put in the challenge for Wales to deflect it behind for a corner to England.
Yeah, tight area for England to have to operate in. It's quite good play just to get into that area. Then all of a sudden, there's that many red shirts in and around the 18-yard box. The ball came out to Bellingham and he just tried to go around the outside and got muscled out of it in the end.
Foden with this corner for England, looking for Maguire, but they had three men around Maguire, Wales. And it's headed away out to Gareth Bale, who takes the ball down and gives it to Davis, who sweeps it forward with his left foot. But Bellingham was there on the halfway line for England. Now Maguire, who's still up there, he's halfway inside the Welsh half. He has Ampadu right with him, so gives it to the right-hand side. Now England move it towards the left. Ramsey just wanders across in front of Stones. So Shaw's got it on the left-hand side, then back to the Stones again. Long raking pass, but straight through the middle into the gloves. I mean, Danny Ward. 5 minutes of added time.
I'm looking at how deep Ampadu and Joe Allen are for Wales. I mean, they can't be further than 5 yards off the toes of the two centre-backs for most of the time. And I think that says a lot in terms of being able to play through. They don't want England to be able to play through the middle of the pitch. They've had one chance through the middle and that was on a turnover. So I don't think they're going to allow England to try and manoeuvre that ball, get a player like Bellingham in that area to turn on the ball and then find those passes, because they're just so deep and on top of each other. The space really has to go wide.
Kane, very deep, gives it to Rashford, who tried to play it back to the far side. Groans from the England supporters as Kyle Walker is in there. Quite a heavy challenge, actually, in the middle of the field, in the centre circle, on Dan James. But it's a free kick, and that's all it is.
Just Wales from behind, isn't it? Just kind of came from the side and behind there, Kyle Walker. He's looked quite good, though. Looked quite physical in this game so far, enjoying the shoulder-to-shoulder challenges.
So in added time at the end of the first half, Wales are coming forward. Wales, at some point, you know, have got to be positive about this. There's only one goal in the other match. In fact, let's get an update from Conor McNamara.
Yes, we're in stoppages at the end of the first half. It is still 1-0 to the USA. The goal from Christian Pulisic, and the USA have been involved in two goals in the tournament. He scored one, he's assisted at the other. Iran have not had a shot in this game so far. As you can imagine, John, the American fans are hooping and hollering and they are very much enjoying what they're seeing here. Iran 0, USA 1 for now.
Well, who'd have thought that? American fans hooping and hollering. Ward passing the ball out towards the far side, but Walker comes and wins the header, but straight at Joe Allen, who's able to take it down. It's Brennan Johnson, by the way, who is getting ready to come on. Oh, Joe Allen's given it away. He's passed it straight to Henderson, and now square to Kane. Kane, 25 yards out, slips it into the edge of the area to Bellingham. Now to Shaw on the left-hand side. Wales just able to clear. It was behind. The pass was actually behind Mepham, who was able to get a touch. Back into the box, though. Kane's going to try the shot. That's deflected from maybe a couple of feet away from the strike of the England captain by Mepham. Took it behind and wide of the goal. Corner again to England.
I mean, on the previous charge, John, I counted 7 red Wales shirts in the penalty area when England had that ball there. And I just think there's so many bodies that they've just got to keep chipping away, England, getting in good areas, maybe having shots from in and around the edge of the box like Harry Kane did there, because for a goalkeeper, any kind of effort on the edge of the box through all those bodies is going to be difficult if the ball just deflects past you.
Foden then with this latest England corner. Again, it's to the back post. Headed back across underneath the crossbar, but caught quite comfortably by Danny Ward, backpedalling. It was John Stones who got the header on the far side of the 6-yard box. And another Welshman has gone down on his knees near the corner of the penalty area. Might be Ampadu.
Yes, Ampadu.
Yeah, so just a little stoppage there, and the referee's gone across. So in added time at the end of the first half, Jane Ludlow.
Well, it's been a pretty uninspiring first half of football, hasn't it? But I think Wales would be relatively happy. If this ends 0-0 first 45 minutes, they'll be relatively happy walking inside and do expect changes when they come out second half, because, you know, everybody knows Wales have to get a result from this today. Now, whether that's younger, fresher legs to come on and try and exploit the space behind England. Who knows? But right now, look, the one thing Wales are doing well is getting bodies in the box and defending for their lives.
That's what they're doing, and they're coming forward actually in the latter stages here of the first half. Ramsey, their throw-in was won off Rashford. Conor Roberts, for some reason, pushed Rashford in the chest. So I think Rashford was trying to stop him getting to the ball to take a quick throw. And that must be something that the referees have been told about, Matt. That's what I take from that, because the referee was all over that. And has come across and told them both off. So it's a throw-in. Roberts to take it. Conor Roberts backs up against the hoardings down on this side of the ground. There's a cameraman virtually following him. Roberts comes up, takes the throw. He actually angles it back towards the... and now Joe Allen's into the area and shoots! Left-footed, but that flies away. Wide of the England goal. Pickford diving to his right, but he was quite comfortable that it was not on target. That's just about the best moment that Wales have had.
Nice throwing play. Nicely worked. That's thought out and premeditated, I think. The throwing goes backwards. Joe Allen just drifts into that little hole and the ball pops into him and he gets a shot off. It was a nice throw-in.
And there's the half-time whistle. Just having a listen to see if there's any reaction from the supporters. But there's actually loud applause from the Wales fans down there. The England fans less so. What an odd campaign it's been for England so far. 6-2 in the first match, starting a match like no other England team has ever done before by scoring six goals in their opening game. Then 0-0 against the United States, and now 0-0 in the first half against Wales.
Yeah, I mean, I think what says it all is I've just spent, just at the end there, 10, 15 seconds describing how good the throwing was from Wales. And that to me says what this 45 minutes has brought, to be honest. It's not been great. We've expected more from England. I think Wales can go in at half-time feeling like it's kind of the mission that they had, and they're halfway along. They haven't conceded. They're still in the game. Got an opportunity to win it. And England need to snub that out, and they need to stamp their authority on this game and start putting something together to be more authoritative, more aggressive, more progressive, more attacking-minded in me, creating chances. And maybe as the game goes on, those moments will open up.
But Jane Ludlow, thing is, Wales have got to win this game, so at some point they've got to throw caution to the wind. Yeah,
and touching what you've just said, the game will open up, won't it? When Wales start doing that and throwing more players forwards and attacking a little bit more and hopefully exploiting some space behind the back line for England, then those gaps are going to open up. And what we've seen in the first 45 minutes is some of the England opportunities have come from those turnovers and transitions. So it should be a more inspiring second 45 minutes, because it's all still to play for.
So it is Wales 0, England 0.
Good throwing routine, wasn't it?
Brilliant throwing. Did you enjoy it?
I'm genuinely can't think of anything else to ask you at the moment. I mean, we can keep eulogising about that.
I know it's it's not good, is it, that we're talking about that? But there isn't that many other moments. Should we take into account the fact that Wales have sat there? I think that's something that you need to look at and go, well, perhaps that is a reason. If it opens up, second half, we'll have another look.
We'll talk more about this game in a moment. The better game of the two tonight, without a shadow of a doubt, is Iran against USA. Plenty of chances for USA. They've just had a second ruled out for offside, Conor McNamara.
Yeah, we've only seen one replay, but it looks very tight, Mark. But the second goal has not been allowed to stand, and it's the Christian Pulisic effort that has got the USA in front here. It's a night that they have to win. A draw could be enough for Iran. But really, it's a game in which the USA have dominated in possession, in terms of territory. There's only been one breakaway counter-attack from the Iranians, and they messed it up. Two attackers up in the penalty area. Taremi tried to lay it back to Osmoun. Probably should have taken it on himself. USA were able to clear away. There was another chance as well for the United States when they were 3-on-2, and between them, Weah and Sargent messed it up. Now we're getting to see that computer-generated image of where they show the offside, and Weah's just stepped in the wrong side of the defender. So correct decision. The second goal doesn't stand, and it's Iran 0, USA 1 at the moment. England and USA going through.
They've continued, haven't they, Connor, with how they played against England, the USA? I mean, just with the energy and the intensity.
Yeah, and And I'd even add to that, you know, and still the lack of a proper number nine. You know, you feel that the amount of getting it out to wide positions, Dest has been excellent, Robinson on the left-hand side delivery, but they don't have anyone in the middle to finish it off. Pulisic was really brave when he scored. He clattered into the goalkeeper. He had to leave their field to receive treatment, but he did come back on again. But you think if USA had a proper number nine, they'd be some team.
Connor, thank you very much. By the way, that game is on BBC Two if you want to watch USA against Iran. Wales, England on BBC. What? Why are you pointing at me?
Because that was absolutely... I don't blame you. I don't blame you.
What, for telling people to go watch BBC
Two? Yeah. I don't blame you.
Basically turn over.
Because that was painful. That was... I mean, the happiest man in the world, in myself, can't even pick positives out of that game.
What about Matt's point of how much you judge it by Wales sitting in?
Yeah, I think we knew Wales were going to do that. They were going to try to keep it tight first half, and then second half they're going to have to take more risks. But this is exactly what happened against USA. It was a low block at times for them, and England just moving the ball too slow. When they get in the offensive third, it needs to be sharp, and every time they have moved the ball quickly, they've got the two chances.
I absolutely agree with that. I cannot bear when teams sit off and players still don't move the ball with intensity. That isn't a license to just go slow and stand on the ball. For me, you've got to move it quicker. And you've got to, because making that pass and even getting it back, the picture then changes a little bit in front of you. It might just be a small change, but it might be enough to then find that ball threaded through or a bit of space over the top.
Yeah, and that's exactly why, when you've got the Rice and Henderson, I think we need a Rice or a Henderson. I don't think we need both of them. And I would have a Foden more in the middle and have a Saka on the right-hand side, because then you've got Bellingham making the runs, you've got Foden gaining that little pocket of space, and you've got Rice shoring it up.
Does Bellingham look as effective to you when he's receiving that ball with his back to play with players all around him? For me, that isn't where I want to see him. I'd rather see Phil Foden do that than Jude Bellingham, to be honest.
Is that for you then, Matt? Is that the midfield area that is predominantly responsible for how quickly that ball is moved along?
No, I think it's a massive responsibility of the centre-backs, to be honest. And the full-back starts there. It's how quickly you want to move that ball. If there's no pressure, you still fire that ball out with intensity. One or two touches. Move it quick. And as you're moving that ball side to side, the team has to move along with you. Wales have to shuffle. Then all of a sudden, you might see that little hole open up. But it's got to be moved quicker.
The centre-backs always control the tempo of the game when you've got possession. When a team sits really deep like that, you've got to step out. Maguire did it on a couple occasions, and apart from, you know, the bad cross, it worked. If you set the tempo slow from the back, then the rest of the team is slow as well. They need to move the ball quicker and get into the areas and try hurt Wales.
Well, the halftime entertainment's just about to start here. And we had a little chat earlier. This man was on Five Live Breakfast this morning as well. And one member of the team, when told that Chesney Hawkes was providing the halftime entertainment, said who? Now, you were... This was number one in 91, I think. So you were...
3 years old.
Three.
Now I gasped. Chappers when he didn't know who.
Oh, I thought you meant you gasped at the excitement of Chesney Hawkes doing the hard time show. I was going to say, well, that balances up Micah not knowing who he is there. Now, when you hear it, Micah, now, is it familiar?
I've never heard this song before in my life, Chappers.
Well, John Murray said to me he was really keen to sing along with the chorus, so.
Well, what I'd say
is... Oh, no, I hit that perfectly for you. Yeah, I hit it perfectly for you.
Well, once a radio, one DJ.
Micah, you've heard of Bing Crosby, haven't you?
Who?
Bing Crosby! Well, and there's the difference in our eras, John. I go Chesney Hawkes, you go Bing Crosby. There we are.
Yeah, but my point is, you know White Christmas, don't you? You know White Christmas, Bing Crosby.
Jane, do you wish you were here?
To be honest, guys, I was hoping you'd stop talking so I can listen. This is a tune. Yeah. This is my era.
My era too. It's very disappointing that Micah doesn't know who he is. And what was great on Five Live Breakfast this morning Chesney Hawke said he's doing the halftime. He said to Rick, he's doing the halftime entertainment. He's only doing one song. And Rick said, so which which one are you doing then? Right, he only had one big hit, basically, Micah. That's the thing.
Micah already knew.
Right.
He already knew. Right.
I've been informed that.
Thank God for Chesney Hawke, because he filled 2 or 3 minutes when I couldn't think of anything else to talk about with the football. Second half on the way. Goalless here. USA lead Iran by 1-0. England and the USA qualifying as things stand. As Chesney rocks it down there, let's just pause for the latest BBC news.
Take the World Cup with you. Qatar 2022. On BBC Sounds. This is BBC Radio 5 Live.
With the BBC News, I'm Jill McKenzie. The UK Health Security Agency says around 20 people could have died because of a mistake in a COVID lab that led to 39,000 positive tests being reported as negative. Experts estimate that the error led to an extra 55,000 infections last year. A man's due at Westminster Magistrates Court tomorrow after being arrested in connection with the deaths of at least 27 people who drowned trying to cross the English Channel last year. The 32-year-old could be extradited to France, where he faces manslaughter charges. The Royal College of Nursing says up to 100,000 nurses will strike in England, Wales and Northern Ireland on the 15th and 20th of December. Action's been suspended in Scotland after the government made a higher pay offer. And for the first time ever, less than half of the population of England and Wales say they identify as Christian. It's now 46%, down from almost 60% in the last census 10 years ago.
Get to work, start a venture, build your network, commit to the vision, knuckle down, pull out the stops, make it happen. I'm Yanni Sharalambos, and this is How We Hustle.
I was going maybe 90%, but that 10% can change your life.
It's one big game and I just want to get the best score and the best win.
This is the podcast where the best in the business talk to us about their hustle.
I understand where I want to go. I appreciate what I've done and where I've been.
Obviously, everything happens for a reason, innit? But I feel like I'll be so missing. It'll be ridiculous.
The hustle continues with season 2 of How We Hustle with me, Yanni.
Whatever I wanted to do, I'd do it.
Listen first on BBC Sounds.
BBC 5 Live. The FIFA World Cup, Qatar 2022, with Mark Chapman.
Fair play to Chesney Hawke. He's just finished. He went a cappella for a while to try and get the crowd singing along, but I'll be honest, there's not much enthusiasm in this stadium. I think that might have something to do with the first half. Jules, you were singing along. Your pitch side, you had a great view.
Sorry, I was just about to have a crisp. Yes, sing along there. It was interesting because he's changed his shirt. He's got a glitter guitar strap and he's an absolute big fan of Declan Rice. He had an England shirt on earlier and he was sitting in the England dugout. And he said, oh, do you think it'll be on the BBC at half time? And I said, well, I'm sure it'll be on the radio. But then, as he was coming out to perform that, Callum Wilson was one of the substitutes. Was on the pitch and he kind of gave him the big thumbs up, but I actually really think he was hoping and that Declan Rice would come to him. And I think when the players were coming out to do their warm-ups before the match, he was sort of hanging around that area. I think he absolutely rinsed the video on his phone and he was like so excited. And as I was walking past to him before that moment, he was sort of saying, this is the closest I'm going to get to Declan Rice wearing an England shirt with Declan Rice on the back. So you're kind of hoping at full time, dependent on the result, dependent on the mood that Declan Rice is in, that he might just go over and have a selfie with him.
Absolutely. Good stuff, Chesney Hawke. The halftime entertainment here. Goalless between Wales and England. USA lead Iran by 1-0. So England would top the group. USA would be second. England would be playing Senegal in the last 16. The USA would be playing the Netherlands. As things stand, Micah Richards, Matt Upson, Jane Ludlow all with us. And for how long do you go more of the same then, Jane, if you're Rob Page?
Oh, that's an interesting question. Look, we got to go for it, haven't we? Wales.
But when?
I for me, it'd be from straight off second half. Let's get out there and let's just throw it at England and see what we get. Because reality check now, we have to throw everything we can at this game. And Wales can't afford to wait till the last 10 minutes, 20 minutes to try and change this match. Rob Page could make that decision, but I'd be surprised if he does.
The other side of that, Mike, is of course as soon as Wales did get up the other end and create either one chance or a half chance, they were vulnerable to the break, weren't they?
Yeah, exactly that. I think They're going to have to open up at some stage. And I think it's just that transition. Kane, again, is coming a little bit too deep. But like we said before the game, when you've got willing runners like Rashford, like they got in for the opportunity, that is what they want to do, exploit them spaces. But I want to see a lot more for England in the second half.
And also, Jane, would you agree that if England did move the ball quicker, that Wales would have issues?
It's going to be a gamble. If Wales, you know, do go on the attack more and we retain the ball better and we attack, look, there's going to be gaps there for England to exploit, and Wales have got to hope that they don't exploit us. And the guys who are left defensive balance-wise have to do a great job for Wales. Reality, Wales have to score some goals in this match.
Big old substitution that's just happened here. Gareth Bale is off and Brennan Johnson is on. So remember, Iran 0, USA 1. If you want to watch that, it is on BBC 2. If you want to watch Wales England, it's on BBC 1. But you can hit the red button and you can get our commentary with the pictures. It's all synced up. It won't be delayed or anything else. And then you can enjoy, hopefully, the second half in the company of Matt Upson and the one and only John Murray.
Very good. Well, that's a big moment. Gareth Bale is substituted. So is that the end of his career in international football? And indeed, what will he do after this match? And clearly the question cannot be answered until we know what's happening to Wales in this tournament. But that could be it, Matt Upson.
Yeah, it has potential, doesn't it, to come off at half-time. And whether or not that's a switch with Brennan Johnson coming on, who's quite a lively, bright young player. He's got a good bit of pace, he can go past players, good runner with the ball. Obviously Gareth Bale is there for those moments, those free kicks, the responsibility of taking penalties, the dealing with the pressure. He's obviously excellent at that, but he hasn't been effective in this game so far. And whether or not Rob Pace just thinks freshening it up in that area of the pitch is an essential thing for Wales in given the situation.
So that is it for the 33-year-old Gareth Bale in this match, and the 21-year-old Brennan Johnson of Nottingham Forest comes on instead. So Johnson on the right-hand side, which is where Gareth Bale was playing, but I mean, he was almost anonymous in the first half, Gareth Bale, and you can understand why the decision
absolutely
was there. Tough decision, but he's made it.
Tough call, but he wasn't effective, wasn't involved in the play or getting on the ball. And Brennan Johnson has an opportunity now to show that he's the player that should start in that position.
Wales 0, England 0. 5 Live, BBC Sounds. The match Wales have to win if they're going to stand a chance of going through. But they need the other match to be a draw, and it is currently Iran 0, USA 1. England just have to, as Ramsey will go for a long pass looking for Brennan Johnson, who I think fouled Luke Shaw. Shaw went down in the D on the edge of the box. I think that was given as a free kick.
Yeah, it was a free kick. Just a little shove and pushing the back on Luke Shaw, but you know, I like the start, the Wales thinking. Brennan Johnson got high up the pitch. He's got the pace to get beyond Luke Shaw if the pass is right and he times his run right. He's capable of getting in on goal if everything comes together.
But Gareth Bale's been involved in so many big moments for his clubs and, of course, for Wales. The free kick that actually got them here against Ukraine in June. Wales have not won since that match. Be interesting to hear what Jane Ludlow's thoughts are on that substitution, on the decision to take off Gareth Bale at half time.
Well, to be fair, I think I saw a stat half time where it was 0% pass completion from Gareth Bale. He hasn't touched the ball. Well, he hardly touched the ball first half. So, it, you know, probably the right decision from Pagey, but a tough one. And look, every Welsh person loves Gareth Bale. We'll always love him for everything he's done for us as a nation so far in his career. Whether that continues or not, we love him to bits.
Thanks, Jane. Wales 0, England 0. 5 Live. And we're watching England coming forward from left to right in this second half. And here's Phil Foden taking the ball up on the left-hand side. Not on the run towards the edge of the penalty area and goes down. And the referee just thought a moment, but then gives it. It's a free kick. The challenge. Foden running at pace at the Welsh defence. You know, that's the sort of exciting play that people want to see from Phil Foden. That's why they wanted him on the field against the United States. And in the end, he was just caught there, I think, by Joe Rodon.
Yeah, it was Rodon with the final touch. But they're the moments you want from Phil Foden, picking the ball up on the left-hand side and driving inside with his right foot, and then actually just turning back onto his left, which drew the tackle and the foul. And again, we're in that territory, aren't we? Kieran Trippier territory. I've seen him stick these in for England, and there's a big debate again. I mean, how many shirts around that ball? Seven?
But it won't be Harry Kane. He's no. walked away from it. It looks as though it's going to be Rashford.
Rashford, yeah. And it,
so the free kick that we saw in the first half, there was a mighty conflag about it. It was worked quite intricately and didn't come to anything. This time, Henderson standing in front of the ball. I mean, from this sort of position, it's 25 yards out, an angle on the left-hand side. You would think that Rashford would go for goal from here.
I would have thought so, with power.
Yeah, and that's what it looks like. Jordan Henderson runs away. So the stage is left to Marcus Rashford with the free kick. Oh, what a free kick! England take the lead, and that was special. Marcus Rashford does it for England. And his teammates race after him down here off the field. And he is engulfed by them all. The opening goal. England lead Wales by 1-0. And Wales' hopes of staying at this World Cup are now absolutely hanging by a thread. And England are heading for the top of the group. Rashford punches the air. What a great moment for him. His second goal at this World Cup. Wales 0, England 1.
Well, we thought he was going to hit it from the position of the ball. And we thought he was going to hit it with power. He certainly did disappoint. It was a great strike. The ball goes in on the goalkeeper's side, so whether or not he's a little bit unsighted, warding goal. He's not standing far enough over to the left for me because he's got his wall on the other side, but take nothing away from the hit. Marcus Rashford's got that lovely ability to hit the ball quite flat with topspin. Gets plenty of dip on the ball and pace and power. And he rockets it into the far corner of the goal. Really good strike from Marcus Rashford.
Wales 0, England 1. And it's the England supporters' voices that you can hear. Wales playing the ball out from the back. The match they have to win, and now they're 1-0 down. Kane on the right-hand side plays it across. Foden arrives at the back post. It's 2-0. And Phil Foden now scores his first goal at a World Cup. Great moment for Rashford, and seconds later, a great moment for Foden. 2-0 England.
I'm just looking at Phil Foden's face. He looks so elated. He doesn't know what to do almost. He's just got this massive beaming smile. Can't believe the opportunity he's just had at the back post to tap that ball home. It's a cross from Harry Kane. England work it really well on the right-hand side. But you have to credit Phil Foden, the way he gets in that far post. He sees the opportunity develop. He just doesn't stand on his heels and stay out of the pitch. He sees Harry Kane get his head up and he whips the ball. It's a brilliant cross. He literally rolls it right in between Ward and Roden. Really nice pace on the ball in. It's so inviting from Harry Kane. He's got one thought in his mind to fizz that ball across the edge of the six-yard box. And there's Phil Foden just arriving. Simple tapping with his left foot, 2-0 England.
Well, there's a moment that Phil Foden will remember for the rest of his days. Starting a match at the World Cup for the first time, Gareth Southgate brought him in and now scoring as well. And England scored 2 in 2 minutes, and Wales have been absolutely shattered by that. Gareth Bale has been substituted. England have scored twice, really, in a matter of seconds, and now their hopes of staying on beyond this match, well, they are fading so quickly, Jane Ludlow.
Oh, what shall I say? I sit here with two different feelings, I'll be honest. I'm a City staff member, so I'm so happy for Phil Foden and doing what we expect him to do, to be fair, when he steps on a pitch. But I sit here also as a Welsh person and somebody who would have been desperate before the start of this game for the lads to do well. But we're not seeing it. And I just hope that they can keep it together now and not fall apart, because that potentially could happen. The game's potentially gone. Is it an opportunity for Rob Page to put younger people on the pitch to gain experience? Potentially, yeah.
Thank you, Jane. Yeah, England now in complete control. It's changed in the almost the twinkling of an eye with those two goals from Rashford and Foden, the two players that Gareth Southgate has brought in tonight, playing in the wide positions either side of Kane, and Kane sets up the goal for Foden.
It's interesting, isn't it, with that team selection. As you've mentioned, John, the players that have been brought in have impacted the game with goals. I mean, we've took a little while to get going. We thought it would open up, or hoped it would open up in the second half, and England have made that happen, in fairness, with that free kick from Rashford. I mean, I had a look again. I think you can ask questions of the goalkeeper, and you shouldn't really get beat that easily on that side. If you're going to set your wall up on the right, you have to cover the other side of the goal better. But it was a really good strike for Marcus Rashford in the corner, and a decent height as well.
So Wales now, it's a forlorn hope, you'd have to say. Ramsey crossing from the right-hand side, but it's beyond Kiefer Moore in the middle. It reaches out here on the left-hand side. The ball driven right across from James, across the face of the England six-yard box and beyond the far post. But a goal kick to England, no one could get a touch in the middle.
A good response from Wales, though, straight at the other end of the pitch. Two good crosses, one Kiefer Moore nearly gets his head on, then Dan James keeps the ball in, puts it onto his right foot and just whips a ball across the face. He's only just bouncing wide of the far post.
Remember the equation tonight coming into this match, what England had to do was avoid a four-goal defeat. Now they're leading by 2-0. And the question is, with this scoreline, 2-0 here, really, who from the other match is going to go through as group runners-up? And what's the latest with that, Conor McNamara?
Well, at the moment it's USA, John. Iran 0, USA 1. But one goal can change everything.
Kiefer Moore
goes
for goal, it's deflected, and that's a very good save by Pickford. He had to adjust very quickly there. Moore had a goal for 25 yards, and Pickford moving to his left, it took a big deflection off the head of
McGuire. John Stones.
Or Stones, was it?
No, it was McGuire.
And yep. Pickford reacted really well to push it away to his right.
Yeah, sometimes as a defender, you're almost better off just leaving that one. As the shot goes in, getting that little touch is sometimes worse for the goalkeeper. He glances it, and Jordan Pickford had to really get to his right-hand side quickly.
Wales' first corner, they take it quickly. Ramsey gives it back to James. James' ball across the box, and then it's headed away, and the offside flag is up in any case. And now Wales are having a go. They're having a go as they did towards the end of the first half, but they're having a go when they're 2-0 down.
Yes, so often the case, isn't it? You know, teams sometimes free up a little bit when they feel it's over, or the pressure isn't there to try and keep that clean sheet, and they can loosen up and go forwards, because like you say, the game at the moment is dead and buried for them, so they have to free up a little bit.
Wales 0, England 2. Substitution in the offing. Juliet Ferrington down pitch side.
Three substitutions, a triple substitution. Trent Alexander-Arnold taking his instruction from Gareth Southgate. Callum Wilson will also be coming on, as to Calvin Phillips. A lot of strapping on that shoulder with Calvin Phillips, but they're all ready. They're getting to the edge of the pitch, and that triple substitution is about to be made. Just very, very quickly, John, on Marcus Rashford, after he scored that goal, he went down to his knees, he pointed to the skies, he crossed his chest before the match restarted and before Phil Foden scored England's second. But the triple substitution now underway.
Yes, England making this triple change, and I think this is an indication that Gareth Southgate now is comfortable, confident that England will win the group, because Harry Kane is coming off, Declan Rice is coming off, and also Kyle Walker, who's made his comeback tonight in terms of starting a match. So changes being made, and let's bring in Micah Richards as well. Things have changed rather, Micah, since we last heard from you.
Absolutely brilliant. Exactly what the game needed. And if you look at England and the way they've set up in the second half, they've pressed the ball, which leaded to the second goal. Great free kick from Rashford. But we talked about Foden and his lack of minutes in this tournament. Even if he's not scoring or assisting, he creates space for others. On this occasion, he nips in at the back post, and he brings so much to this team. And for me, I'd be starting him every game.
Matt?
Yeah, I agree. I love his reaction, because he is a fair way back when Harry Kane wins the ball or gets the ball at his feet. He has to make up a lot of ground to get in at that far post, but he's got this kind of brain that identifies things so quickly. So he's able to react, sprint into that back post. Okay, it's a simple tapping, but it's all about the vision of seeing it and then getting yourself into that area. I thought he did that excellent.
So, Wales 0, England 2. And play has still not resumed, because there's a stoppage And we're actually going to see Ben Davis taken off the field. Now, what the problem was there with him isn't entirely clear. Joe Morrell of Portsmouth is being sent on by Rob Page. And Ben Davis is walking away, I see down there, the Tottenham man, and walking away down the tunnel with his head bowed. So, 2-0 to England. England heading through as group winners with this scoreline. And Iran-USA latest, Conor McNamara?
Yeah, jeopardy here. Iran need a goal or their World Cup comes to an end tonight. Iran 0, USA 1. Pulisic, who scored just before half-time, had to be substituted during the break. He was injured in the process of scoring the goal. Saman Geddos, the Brentford player, has come on and he's had a chance for Iran to put it over the crossbar. That's been their only decent opportunity so far. But one goal can change everything here. Iran 0, USA 1.
Thank you, Conor. So England making those three changes, Matt Upson, as the ball goes back to Danny Ward, who passes it out from the back. And then Joe Allen's put under pressure. And Morrell, who's just come on in midfield, ball played to the left-hand side. Conor Roberts has now moved across to the left flank.
Yep.
So there's been a little rejig by Wales and Rob Page.
Yeah, I think the England substitutions are not too surprising. Maybe the plan for Kyle Walker all along might have just been an hour. We're just about on that hour mark now. Nil of substitutions, you know, they make total sense for me. Declan Rice played nearly every minute. Harry Kane, he'll play every minute. So to give those guys a break and an opportunity for Calvin Phillips and Alan Wilson, you know, will do the squad the world of good.
Yeah, what we're seeing there is, you know, these players being given an opportunity for a bit of game time, you know, to use the squad, and also something of an international comeback as well for Callum Wilson and Trent Alexander-Arnold, and Calvin Phillips making his comeback from injury. As Jordan Henderson is caught by Ramsey. He was running away from Aaron Ramsey and he's caught him there and he's gone down, and it was right next to one of the pitch side microphones.
Didn't sound good, did it? Really didn't sound good. It was a poor tackle from Aaron Ramsey from behind. He catches Jordan Henderson, who's still laying on the floor holding his right ankle. And he let out a really big yelp.
Yeah, he did. It was a blood-curdling scream.
Yeah,
actually,
his ankle, I just seen the replay. His ankle's turned and kind of just plants in the turf as the tackle comes in from Ramsey. Really catches that right ankle of Jordan Henderson. Looks nasty on the replay.
And a yellow card for Aaron Ramsey. So 2-0 to England. Where do Wales go, Jane Ludlow, now in this? What do they do? I mean, it's a vain hope, isn't it? But I suppose while there's hope.
Yeah, look, if you're standing on that touchline tonight, I think definitely Rob Page's thoughts now are the future. And how do you use the next 30 minutes of this game to benefit the national team, the Welsh national team going forwards? And is that giving opportunities to the younger generation of players so that they get used to the pressure of playing in these tournaments and playing against the calibre of player that they've come up against tonight?
Well, Jordan Henderson has got to a feet and it looks as though he's okay. It's clearly a painful one, but he's all right and he's able to walk back onto the field.
The trouble with those is it's one of those where tomorrow morning your ankle could be twice the size. It's that kind of ankle roll. Hopefully it's not, and hopefully be able to just settle it down and ice it up and it'll be fine. But he's moving about okay. He's done well to get back on his feet and he's just kind of running it off.
Five Live at the World Cup. We'll have all of the reaction and debate and analysis on the Five Live World Cup Daily podcast from BBC Sounds. That's where you can rewind the live radio as well. Not sure I'd necessarily encourage you to rewind the first half of this match, but there we are as Wales win a free kick for a foul on Joel Rodon.
Think they'll be able to rewind the half-time entertainment.
Well, maybe they can.
Listen to a bit of Chesney Hawks.
Yeah, well, why not?
That could be worth it.
What a good suggestion, mate. Good idea. And England, you know, how much has that changed our view on what's happening here tonight? What happened in those 2 minutes early in the second half when Rashford and Foden scored?
Well, I think, you know, that is exactly what this game needed. It's what England needed to do in terms of coming out in the second half and assert their authority on the game. And, you know, Wales came out and looked to be a little bit more open. I think we worked the ball quite nicely. The moments of quality, weren't they? And they were few and far between in the first half. We didn't really see hardly any, did we? So Marcus Rashford with a really nice free kick, Harry Kane, good delivery into the box, Phil Foden arriving, just better key moments for England.
Another thing that occurs to me, is that the first goal that we've seen direct from a free kick at this World Cup?
We haven't seen that, you're asking me a question now. I've seen a few goals. I can't actually picture too many that go direct from a free kick.
So Marcus Rashford scoring from round about 25 yards. It was beautifully struck as well, but I know that you had reservations. And here is Danny Ward, who pulls the ball onto his left foot and clears to the halfway line. Rodon is okay, offside flag against Rashford, and it's a free kick to Wales.
Reservations about the goalkeeping?
Yeah.
Yeah, I just think, you know, I listen to goalkeepers and they're talking about these kind of things, and it's, if you've got your wall one side, and you get beat the other side where you're supposed to be guarding that part of the goal, it's never a good look. I think if somebody bends it over the wall into the opposite top corner or whatever, you have to kind of give them a little clap, but getting beat on your side is not acceptable.
The Moroccan Abdelhamid Sabiri scored.
So there's been one.
Yes, so there has been one. Scored the first free kick of this World Cup. I think I was probably driving off into the desert at that stage, so Trippier is coming on.
Probably.
Yes. Having taken the wrong turn. Trippier is on and Shaw comes off, and I'm not surprised by that either, because, you know, Luke Shaw is a very important player for England at this World Cup as the left back.
Yep, and it's great to have the versatility of Kieran Trippier, isn't it? You can fill in on that right side or look very comfortable at left back and take a decent free kick as well.
Yep, it means that Kieran Trippier can have a go on that side as well in the closing stages of this match. I mean, I know he's played there before, obviously, many, many times, but not at this World Cup yet. So Trippier is on. Wales 0, England 2, and Wales going all the way back to goalkeeper Ward. Back to Iran-USA, Conor McNamara.
Yeah, USA still in position to go through behind England into the last 16 as things stand. We've got just over a quarter of the match to go. The Christian Pulisic goal was the difference. Iran haven't been as good today as they were against Wales, but remember, both Iran goals against Wales came in stoppage time on Friday. They won't give up to the very end, and one goal which had an equaliser for Iran here, they would move into second place in the group.
I think Iran have scored goals in the 8th, the 11th and the 13th minutes of added time at this World Cup. Ball's out of play for a throw-in to Wales inside their own half, but England have got complete control now in this match, and I think you can take your pen out and you can go to your wall chart and you can begin to write Netherlands against USA and Senegal against England.
We spoke at half-time, you said to me about that Wales are going to have to come out in the second half, and I said to you, I'm not sure if they can come out and actually be effective and get hold of the ball, and I think it's been such a tricky game for them to be able to get hold of the ball, and they just haven't had it all game really.
Maybe don't like USA just yet, Conor McNamara.
Don't fill in your wall chart yet, because Iran have had their best chance. Get us again, the halftime substitute. He tried to wrap his foot around it. He's about 12 yards out. This is a glorious chance. He slightly has to step back onto it, and then he puts the laces through it. But that is the biggest let-off for the United States. They remain 1-0 in front, and at the moment they are going through. But that's the best we've seen from Iran.
Well, that's where the drama is now. England with the ball at the back, Pickford playing it out to Stones to his right, and Stones chips it forward, and Alexander-Arnold now back to Calvin Phillips, and Phillips hits a long pass with the top of his right foot over the top to Rashford. What a good pass that was. Rashford into the penalty area, and Rashford shoots and scores! Straight through Danny Ward. That's a bad one for the Welsh goalkeeper, but Rashford scores his second goal of the match. And England lead by 3-0. And England can prepare to go through into the knockout stages as the group winners.
Well, I just love so many different things about that goal. I love how direct it was. I love the vision of Calvin Phillips to be able to chip that ball over the top, knowing he's got the pace of Marcus Rashford to get behind the right back, who had a little gamble on the shorter ball. And Rashford was the wrong side. Calvin Phillips sees it, brilliant ball over the top, and from this position he's got a couple of options, Marcus Rashford. He could set Callum Wilson But such is his confidence after that free kick. He's on a roll at the moment. Third goal in the tournament. He drifts it onto his left foot, and it's just a lovely clean strike. It goes through Ward's legs in goal. Could maybe save it if he's really in a good position with his feet, but it just hits the inside of his heel and goes into the back of the net because he hits it with real power. It's just such a confident goal from Marcus Rashford.
So Wales 0, England 3. Two goals for Rashford. He's on a hat-trick. Phil Foden scoring the one in between. And Rashford looks alive.
Yeah, confident. And you can tell, can't you, that just the fact that he's took that chance on with his left foot tells you where he's at in terms of feeling that he can score, and that's, you know, brilliant for England.
So mentioned, for Marcus Rashford, this is only the second match that he's started at a World Cup or a European Championship, and it's his fourth tournament. You know, lots of substitute appearances. It's actually his 15th appearance, but only his second start.
So, you know, straight away, what that does to you mentally, you know, you've been to so many tournaments and not really played a part and just been, you know, training and part of the squad, it's not easy. And I think, you know, getting this opportunity for him, he must be feeling that I've got to grab this with both hands. If I get on the grass, I've got to show my worth, and he's done that in this World Cup.
Long ball downfield for Wales, Kiefer Moore gets his chest to it, Dan James tries to get there, but England, Calvin Phillips it is, comes across, and then Trent Alexander-Arnold hits a high pass downfield looking for Callum Wilson through the middle. But Joe Allen is back in possession.
He just sees
Wales.
Passes, Trent Alexander-Arnold, that he just no one else sees, you know, and he's got the technical capability to execute it.
Brennan Johnson receives it from Ramsey, and Brennan Johnson pulls it across, but John Stones is able to step across, and Phil Foden is able to play it downfield at the halfway touch. Line. Wilson,
it's a shame.
Kirsten there.
Great touch, wasn't it? Yes, first touch was there from Callum Wilson. Brilliant hold up, but just misplaced his pass.
That's Matt Upson, played for England at the World Cup, scored for England at the World Cup. Jane Ludlow is with us tonight as well, back in the BBC studio. And the game's up, Jane, I'm afraid, isn't it, for Wales?
Yeah, once that second goal went in, it was up then. But I think, you know, the third goal, when you look at that from a Welsh perspective, it's a trend of this World Cup has been how poor Wales have been pressing in the opposition half. And you can see why Robert Page decided to go with a low block first half to try and give Wales a chance, because it's a part of our game that in previous campaigns has been phenomenal. It's been great, but in this World Cup, it's been awful. Our pressing organisation opposition half has just kept, it's just left us wide open defensively. Our back four have struggled to be able to compete.
Morel deflects the ball into the path of Wilson, and Wilson now up to the edge of the area, and Rashford could be in for the hat-trick, but hits the shot, and it's saved by the left foot of Danny Ward. The shot from an angle, and Ward saves it with his left foot.
Well, Rashford wants that hat-trick. He's desperate for it. He's put loads of energy, loads of runs. Getting wide is completely different to the first half in the way that England are attacking, and I know the game's changed completely, but we're just going forward in surges, lots of white shirts, movement, overlapping players, and Rashford with his right foot strikes it. Not the most powerful of strikes, easily saved by Ward, but nonetheless, it's another effort on goal from him.
In actual fact, in the second half, suddenly England are the England that played against Iran.
Yeah.
It's a corner then from the right. Foden plays it in, and Danny Ward's able to come and make the catch. And he has that ball in his hands. So, USA 1-0 up against Iran. Currently, England going through as group winners, and USA as runners-up, and Wales in danger of losing the ball on the edge of their own box, and Foden has slipped into a challenge there, and just keeping an eye on him because he's stayed down, and I think he's been caught. And now it's Wales at the other end with Johnson, who will shoot from the angle, but that's blocked by Trippier. And just looking at Phil Foden, who's climbing to his feet, and he's in a little bit of pain there. And this is a worry for England.
Yeah.
It was a slip. They slipped into the challenge. And
Marcus Rashford.
And Rashford has also sat down.
Yeah, cramp. Marcus Rashford is just stretching his calf out, but the Foden one.
Foden's on his feet. Foden is on his feet.
It's a bit awkward, wasn't it? He tried to put the brakes on with the tackle with Rodon. He just got his right ankle just caught underneath him as Rodon comes in.
Ooh, there was like he jarred it in the turf, actually, his right right ankle. Juliet Farrington had a view from the pitch side.
Yeah, I'm just watching him now, and he just sort of bent over again to give it a little feel. I think it's his right ankle. It was just a clash, a collision, or the sliding
he slid with Roden around him. Just on Marcus Rashford, he's now joined top goal scorer in the race for the Golden Boot. John, I thought you would have had that one
there's
ready.
There's a few of them there. It's a log jam on three, Jules. I won't run through them just at the moment. Wales 0, England 3. What's happening in Iran, USA, Connor?
Yes, there's less than 20 minutes to go plus the stoppages, so this is very, very tense now for Iran. Iran 0, USA 1. USA have not been able to turn the screw. They haven't been able to add to Christian Pulisic's opening goal just ahead of half-time. And Iran are beginning to sense they might be creeping into it. A double change. Dekali and Torabi have both come on. It is Iran 0, USA 1.
So it's in the balance for the United States, but not so for England. 3-0 up, two goals for Rashford. Foden seems to be okay. And Rashford, just think it was a little bit of cramp, Matt.
Yeah.
So England had the ball at the back and winning a throw-in in the left-back position. And I think Gareth Southgate is just having a look. He's made now the England manager. Four of his changes. And it is Jack Grealish who is coming on now. Well, no mercy here against the tiring Wales who are heading out of the World Cup. And that's it, it's Marcus Rashford actually. So I think that tells us that Phil Foden is okay. Otherwise, Foden would be off the field now. And Rashford, who just looks a little bit as though he's been affected by that cramp, walks off the field. Two goal Marcus Rashford, what a great night for him. And Gareth Southgate comes across and puts his left arm around his shoulders and says, well done, young man.
Yeah, absolutely. Big pat on the back for him. He's had a great evening. Started with a massive opportunity for him and he has grabbed it with both hands, something that I really feel he needed to do. And he's done it well and he gets a good standing ovation from England fans to our right behind the goal who fully appreciated his job tonight.
Yeah, he had the chance to get the hat-trick, but England with the ball deep inside their own half. It's been run forward by Bellingham, who passes it cross-field. Alexander-Arnold's able to get the ball under control, and he will have a look forward and actually set off on a run himself, Alexander-Arnold, up towards the centre circle to Callum Wilson. And then Alexander-Arnold again in the challenge, now out of position. He's fouled Joe Morel, so it is a free kick.
I think you can also take from this game that Jude Bellingham likes playing that slightly deeper role for England. To me, looks so at home, so comfortable, doing a defensive job, winning balls back in his own half, and that driving run, whether he goes past the player or passes it and gets it back. But I just love seeing him come from deep, as opposed to receiving the ball with his back to goal and having to work in that area of the pitch.
Harry Wilson has replaced Dan James. It's been given away by Ramsey. Wilson takes it up to the edge of the area and he gives it to his left. And it's struck goalwards by Bellingham. It's saved and then turned wide in the six-yard box somehow by Phil Foden, who had the goal in front of him. There were a couple of defenders coming in. He was slightly off balance and he hooked it wide somehow.
Well, unbelievable miss, really. It's a decent save from Ward. It was a bad mistake from Wales that gave the ball away initially, and Callum Wilson was able just to pick the ball up and he's driving at the edge of the penalty box. It's a nice pass to his left to Bellingham on his right foot. He tries to bend it round to the far post with his right foot, but it's a little bit central. Ward gets down and deals with it, and then the rebound, can't turn that in either, but poor mistake from Wales. They've got to make sure they don't give loose balls away like that and make the scoreline even worse for themselves.
Yeah, Wales coming forward, but this is it. This is the end of this World Cup journey for Wales here tonight. They've been able to get through the knockout stages at every World Cup or European Championship that they've played at, but not at Qatar 2022. It really hasn't happened for them.
No.
And they have looked like a team at the end of the cycle.
Yeah. It looked a bit tired at times, hasn't it? And not got that freshness or energy to be able to impact the game or even change the game, which is where I think they've been really disappointed.
Still USA lead Iran by 1-0, so they are going through as group runners up. But that match in the last 16 I think you can put that on your wall chart. Senegal against England. And that is on Sunday, the 4th of December. It'll be 7 o'clock in the evening. And that will be up at the Al Bayt Stadium in the north of Doha here. Tonight, we're out to the west. And after this, Wales will be heading back west, back home. And with just the 1 point that they were able to get from the opening draw against the United States. Marcus Rashford with his goals tonight, joining Enner Valencia, Kylian Mbappe and Cody Gakpo, who are on three. So we talked about Harry Kane as the potential Golden Boot winner, Matt, but instead...
Yeah, I mean, it's a tough call before a competition. You'd always put him as a name in and amongst the list, wouldn't you, with his goal record. But Harry Kane will just be delighted that, that England are progressing. And I think that for him, he's got massive personal goals, obviously. But for England to be successful, to play in those big semis or finals or even win a World Cup, for him is just an amazing experience.
And he's set up another goal tonight.
Yeah, he has. He's played his part, hasn't he?
And if you remember at the Euros last year, it was Sterling who scored the goal in the group. And it was only in the knockout stages that Kane actually began to get on the score sheet. Scored four goals in the knockout stage.
Well, it's great you're getting goals from all over the pitch. It's another key thing for any good team that you can score from different areas of the field, from midfield. Even if centre-backs can weigh in, defenders, wide players, it all helps.
It's another stoppage for an injury. I think that is going to be it for Joe Allen, who clearly was absolutely desperate. Rob Page was desperate to have him here. You know, they've worked wonders to get him fit to play at this World Cup because of the hamstring injury that he suffered at Swansea. But that is it. He was able to come on as a substitute in the previous match, started this match, but that's it for him, Jane Ludlow.
Yeah, look, it's been great to get him on the pitch, if you're a Welsh fan, because another great servant for the national team. But it's also good, look, take positives from this. It's good to see the younger generation getting on the pitch now, and let's see what they can do. Look, it's not about getting the result in any shape or form tonight. It's about getting some exposure for our younger lads to start that transition process and look further ahead.
Yeah, which is exactly what he's doing, Rob Page, bringing on Reuben Colwill of Cardiff, the 20-year-old, for a taste of the World Cup action, even if it is in a situation where Wales are 3-0 down to England here after England have significantly upped it in the second half. And they have, haven't they? This second half performance has been reminiscent of the performance against Iran.
Yeah, it's gone up a couple of gears from the first half, and whether or not it's partly because of Wales, but England have to take credit of that.
Here is Grealish into the action. Ball to Bellingham inside the penalty area, but it bounces away from him. And Wales are able to clear it away downfield. We're into the last 10 minutes now. The thought will be in the closing stages to take commentary on the closing minutes of Iran against the United States, because that match will decide who plays against the Netherlands on Saturday. And the other thing as well is, with England playing on Sunday, that is now, you know, that's a significant gap now, which is the way that the draw has worked out. And England always knew this from the moment the draw was made in Doha on April the 1st, that if they were able to progress as group winners, they would have a significant break before the group and the next stage.
Yeah, it certainly plays a part, doesn't it, in making the landscape as good as what you can for yourself in tournament football in terms of recovery and preparation. It does make a difference.
Ball played over the top for Wales, and Harry Maguire hauls down Kiefer Moore, which that could easily have been a yellow card.
It could.
For
he
Harry
had hold
Maguire.
Of his shirt, big and handful of Kiefer Moore's shirt.
He's been fortunate there.
Yeah.
Because you do not want, as one of the central defenders, to head into the knockout stages on a yellow card.
No.
And England are yet to pick one up.
Yeah, absolutely. And it just got the wrong side of him. I think he just didn't read the situation quick enough. Kiefer Moore got the wrong side, and then he was grappling with him to bring him back.
So it is a free kick. England want to keep a clean sheet here tonight as well. Free kick is going to be taken for Wales by Harry Wilson, the recently arrived substitute. Harry Wilson, the Fulham man, is just wiping his brow with his left wrist, and Wilson hits the free kick into the wall. It bounces back for the Wales number 8 on the far side. He's going to allow it to bounce out of play for a throw in. So back to Iran USA. Conor McNamara's watching the pictures.
18 minutes on the stadium clock, and the United States hanging on to this 1-0 lead that they have because of Christian Pulisic's goal. There's a free kick to Iran. It is midway inside the United States half. They haven't had many of these attacking set pieces in the game. Remember, one goal would change everything. If there could be an equaliser here, Iran would go through. If it finished 1-1, USA would go home, even though they wouldn't have lost a game at this tournament. And just as they're about to take the free kick, the Americans are going to use a little bit of time wasting here and make a double change. But for the moment, John, Iran 0, USA 1.
As the Wales with Colwell has a go for goal from just outside the area, but it flies away over the top of the England crossbar. So Wales 0, England 3. We will have a choice of listening, by the way, later in the evening for you. Five Live Sport will continue until 6:06 at 10 o'clock. So Robbie Savage and Chris Sutton will take your calls. But also, Radio 1 are putting out a celebration playlist of tracks tonight, straight after the match, which was going to be, depending on which team were in the ascendancy tonight, maybe it would have been a Welshman, maybe it would have been an Englishman. It is going to be Jordan Pickford's choice that you will hear on Radio 1 straight after this match.
Do you think he'll have picked Chesney Hawks?
Who knows? Who knows?
Hopefully.
That would be it. I wonder when the last time that was played on Radio 1. Wales 0, England 3. Back to Iran, USA. Connor?
Stopping moment for the United States. Across from the right-hand side for Iran as the American defence tried to step out. There was this corridor of uncertainty. They were all onside. And the goalkeeper, Matt Ryan, held his nerve as the ball came in. It bounced off one of the Iranian attackers. There was an appeal. It may have come off an arm of a defender, Moore, who's just come on. But I think he'll get away with that. And it's Iran 0, USA 1. USA going through as it stands.
England just knocking the ball around inside their own half. The damage was done in the early part of the second half of the match. England scoring their goals in the 50th, 52nd and 68th minutes. And after that, the game was up. Callum Wilson now takes the ball on through the middle. Nice touch from him. Does look sharp, doesn't
he? He looks sharp. He really has, Callum Wilson. The first game and since he's come on today, he looks right at it for any little inkling of ball over the top, down the side. He just tried to throw a nice little shift of body weight there to throw. I think it was rolled in the wrong side, and then he could just go straight at the goal. And I think he's just got this direct mindset at the moment. It's a good player to bring on when the game's a little bit stretched.
Yeah, having had to wait, well, 3 years actually in between caps before he got this recall on the back of his Newcastle form. And and England with the ball inside their own half, played up towards the figure of Jack Grealish there, but he's beaten to the ball, and Wales will come forward again. And a long pass looking for Moore on the edge of the box, who chests it down onto his right foot and curling a shot wide and high. And Harry Maguire and John Stones, there are low fives in there. John Stones watched him, forced him onto the right foot, and he couldn't get it on target.
That was a good touch from keeper Moore, just pulled off, brought the ball down on his chest, good control. But John Stones was a good distance away, matched him stride for stride, just shuffling to try and block the shot. And in the end, Kiefer Moore just curled it with his right foot. It was high and wide.
So it's been a good night in the end for England and for Gareth Southgate and Phil Foden. I don't know who will get to interview after the match tonight. Rashford and Foden obviously will be on the list. We'll hear from Gareth Southgate as well in that hour, and reaction as well from the Welsh camp. I'm sure it'll be delighted Phil Foden. That was his first goal in 17 England appearances. Scored, if you remember, the two goals against Iceland at Wembley, but has not scored since. So great night for him. We'll keep you posted on what happens here at the Ahmed Bin Ali Stadium in the final minutes of this match. But England are going through as group winners, comfortable group winners. We'll be back here in a moment or two. But first, the final stages of Iran, USA with Conor McNamara.
John, 5 minutes of normal time to play, and this is still in the balance. Iran 0, USA 1. Christian Pulisic scored the goal just before halftime, bravely bundling it over the line before colliding with the goalkeeper. He was to pick up an injury in that incident. He couldn't celebrate the goal at all. He's tried to soldier on to the break, but did not resume for the second half. And I think it's fair to say that the United States have missed Christian Pulisic in this second half. They haven't had a shot on target in the second period. Now Josh Sargent has had to go off as well. He's been hurt. And they are lacking a bit of presence up front. Hadji Wright has come on. Shaquille Moore, Brendan Aronson of Leeds United has Iran have possession, and they know that one goal here not just would draw them level in the game, it would move them ahead of the United States in the group. So this is high jeopardy now for the United States as Ezeloy plays it down the right-hand side, trying to pick out Jalali, one of the substitutes who's come on. It comes back to Rezian, the player who scored against Wales last time out on Friday. USA are playing so deep here, they're pretty much all inside their final third. Semen Gottos of Brentford, who had a good opportunity in the second half, but he put it over the top, and then that's a poor ball played over the United States defenders, and it carries all the way through to Matt Turner, and the goalkeeper falls down on the ball, and there's a few boos and cheers and a few hollers of a vuvuzela as well, which has been the implement of choice for Iranian fans inside the stadium. There has been a yellow card shown to Hossein Kanani for dissent. It's a game that in the main has been competitive, but we haven't had too many nasty challenges in the game. We've had, I think, two yellow cards now, as down the left-hand side, a chance for the United States to attack. And Hadji Wright, lovely ball into the penalty area. Aronson's cross in. This could be it for the USA. Shaquille Moore, but he's off balance. Inside the penalty area on the right-hand side. He couldn't get his body angle the right way, and he couldn't get the shot on target. And Iran are able to clear it. A second goal for USA here would turn the screw, would seal the deal. But they're hanging on at the moment. The clock ticks on. 87 minutes on the clock. Iran 0, USA 1. England is still leading Wales by 3-0, and they're into the final 20 seconds of normal time there. This second half started a little bit behind the England game. Defending for USA to do. Robinson couldn't get there before the cross comes in, but the ball is headed away by Shaquille Moore, and he takes no chances. And even though there was no opponent around him, he's headed it out to give a throw-in to Iran, and they are back underway again, and a chance to deliver into the penalty area by poor Ali Janji, who's the centre-half, who's playing up like a midfield now, because Iran have got to throw the kitchen sink at this. Iran 0, United States 1. USA, who've had a couple of draws coming into this game, they've played well in their opening matches, struggled to score goals. Pleased to have got that goal from Christian Pulisic in this one, but will it be enough? Because USA have not looked like adding to the tally. Iran come on the attack with Jalali down the left-hand side this time, and that's a good crunching tackle. Shaquille Moore tracks him all the way to the byline and slides in, and the ball goes out of play out by the corner flag, but for a throw-in on the left-hand side for Iran, who will remain on the... It's going to be a corner. It went out on the corner kick side of the corner flag. Iranian fans up on their feet, still supportive, still believing that the one goal could come here. This really feels like sudden death football. Ball comes in, Tim Ream dramatically falls to the ground. Referee spotted that, but waves play on, and possession will be cleared away up towards the halfway line, where Aronson with the bright yellow boots tries to skip away from two defenders, and the ball goes out of play, and that will be a throw-in to the United States, who are almost there. 2 minutes of the regulation, 90 to go. Back to the Wales-England game, and John Murray.
We're into the second of 4 minutes of added time. Wales 0, England 3. Could easily have been a fourth for England. Ball played in from the right-hand side. Maguire headed it back across, and John Stones on the edge of the six-yard box put it over the bar. So still just 3-0 to England.
Thanks very much, John. Here it is, still on that knife edge. Iran 0, USA 1. So much talk in the build-up, the politics, the history between these two nations. They met at the 1998 World Cup. They don't meet often in other sports. They don't meet often in diplomatic circles. There is always a bit of an edge, and then you bring into the the whole factor of things, the current situation, the anti-government protests in Iran at the moment, the scrutiny of players who looked uncomfortable singing the national anthem, but they did so in the build-up to this game, as the USA come again with Yunus Musa, who's only 20 years of age. His birthday today, and he's had a storming performance in the midfield. This time he gives it away. Ball over the top by Tarabi is way too far in front of the front men. Taremi won't get there, and the pass from Tarabi runs all the way through to Matt Turner, and the United States are almost there. The clock ticks on into the 90th minute now. We will find out shortly what is going to be added on for the stoppages. But this is a game in which Iran will feel they've never really got out of third, fourth gear. USA were dominant in terms of possession and indeed territory in the first half. They had plenty of chances. They were delighted when the goal did come for Pulisic. It was a header back across the edge of the six-yard box. There's going to be 9 minutes. 9 minutes added on here. There is quite a way to go. There is time for Iran. The goal came from Des Header back across the six-yard box. Pulisic bravely running in, beating the goalkeeper, getting it over the line, and then crunching in and hurting himself in the process. But that's the goal that could be about to send the United States through. England already on their way to that last 16, and the United States within a whisker of joining them, it would appear. They're almost done and dusted in the Wales-England game. England still 3 goals to the good. All the goals in the second half. Iran trying to muster some late drama here. Godos back in the midfield to Ezatoloy. He gives a short pass to the right-hand side, and it's played up to, in front of Reiselan on the right-hand side, but he can't find any way through. And the United States have still got energy in the boots. There's still petrol in the tank as they suck oxygen into those lungs and close down the options. Chance to attack for Jalali. Down the left-hand side, swings in across, and back there, Tim Ream is able to clear the ball away. Walter Zimmerman, by the way, has also come on as a further defensive reinforcement for the United States of America, who lead by a goal to nil. It stays like this, they're through. Iran just need one goal. Now they want a free kick, the Iranians, on the edge of the penalty area, but the referee's not interested in the appeals. And the full-time whistle has gone in the Wales-England game. Back to John Murray.
It has finished. Wales 0, England 3. Stodgy in the first half, but England turned it on in the second. Rashford scored 2. Phil Foden scored as well on his first start at a World Cup. There could have been more too. So that's it for Wales. This World Cup journey is over for them. And England go through as group winners. Gareth Southgate said their first objective in Qatar was to win the group. That's what they've done after a 3-0 win here at the Ahmed Bin Ali Stadium.
Podlos board until 10, and we'll have 6:06 coming up. But all the reaction with Mark Chapman once the live game finishes here. Iran, USA, 1-0 to the United States, but a free kick to the Iranians. And Rezaei plays it in. There's a diving header just wide. Hands down, the best chance that Iran have had in the game so far. It's the central defender for Ali Ganji, and that was so agonizingly close for Iran. He's diving header, he's bravely throwing his head down where boots and shin guards are, and he puts it about a foot and a half wide. Matt Turner, the goalkeeper, diving to his right hand side, so relieved to see that off target. Iran are not out of this yet. I've just seen a stat that says in the last 15 minutes Iran have had over 85% possession. That is the late heat that they are putting on their opponents here, and the United States are struggling to contain them. Remember, we spoke about it earlier on, those late goals that the Iranians tend to muster up. 5 of the last 8 goals that they have scored in tournaments have come very, very late, after the 90 minutes are up. Each of the last 8 goals that Iran have scored in a World Cup have been in the second half of games. They tend to get better as games go on, and the United States are looking at the clock, which is slowly ticking on, and we still have in excess of 5 minutes of stoppage time to play. Still 1-0 to the United States of America. This would be a huge victory for them if they can go through to the last 16. The ball is back with Behrendvand, who suffered that concussion against England. The Iranian goalkeeper missed the Wales match as a result. Back in tonight though for Iran, and he clears the ball away, and it goes out of play for a throw-in, and Robinson will take his time over this. Anthony Robinson, who's had a good game on the left side of the defence for the United States. He attempts a very long throw-in, trying to get it down to Shaquille Moore. And the ball goes out of play, and it'll be another throw into the United States. And they will, of course, take their time over this and try to add to some of the frustration that the Iranians are feeling now. Iran need a goal. In order to get that, they need possession. They get it back with Rizian. That's a good pass down the right-hand side. And Godas shows a clean pair of heels to get away from Adams, but he's run it out of play. Good acceleration, and I think he might have tweaked his calf sprinting after that because he's hobbling now. But he ran away from Adams, but he ran the ball out of play. And the United States of America edge closer to what would be a famous victory, their first of this World Cup in Qatar 2022. Gamesmanship from Tyler Adams, the United States captain, as he wastes as much time as he can ahead of this throw-in. Now Anthony Robinson puts the ball up his shirt to wipe it, and again add to the frustrations the Iranians are feeling. The throw-in from the left full-back position, up into midfield. Hadji Wright, the substitute, tries to control it. Harrison won't keep it in play. The ball has gone out for a throw into Iran. They've got it back inside the American half, and there is still at least 3 minutes of stoppages to go. Here come Iran with Aboulfaz Jalali on the left-hand side. Runs in to the energetic Yunus Musa. That's very good from Musa. And then Jalali's frustrated and he bites back and he's going to see yellow for that. And it's a free kick to the United States of America. And you can bet that they will take their time over this. The USA, who've had two draws coming into this third and deciding match. It was the group that was still technically all open. All four teams could have gone through tonight. Obviously, Wales would have needed a miracle, and that hasn't happened, and they've been beaten by England by 3-0. More reaction to come very shortly here on 5 Live to that. But this is the closing stages of Iran against the USA, and it is still there for Iran. There is still the hope, which will be agonizing for them at the moment. Shaquille Moore on the right-hand side has given the ball away. That's a really poor pass. Mohammadi goes long and searching. Acrobatic header by Tim Ream to get the ball away. Now the Americans have to sprint backwards again as Iran pump it down the right-hand side, and Ream comes across and uses all his experience there, does a little dummy knowing that the ball would go out for an American throw, and that just takes some of the simmer off the boil again as the Iranians are beginning to dramatically run out of time now. By my clock, 2 minutes of stoppages to go. There may be a little bit more added on. The Spanish referee does glance at his wristwatch as Iran immediately regained possession. And USA, when they look back at this game, they'll be so disappointed at how they failed to retain the ball in this second period. They've had the one goal lead, but they've not looked comfortable in it at all. Good lead by Walker Zimmerman to head the ball away. The USA playing with three centre halves now. Ream, Carter Vickers and Zimmerman as they try to get it away, but they can't hold it up again. Everyone's on the attack for Iran. Carter Vickers inside the penalty area puts a big right boot on it and clears it away, but there's no one upfield for the United States, and this will be Iran to attack once more down the left-hand side, but it's held up in quite heavy traffic there. It's all become very feisty in a scramble now. It's scrappy football. This is like something of the street, but that is how the Americans will like it at the moment as the clock ticks on, and we're now into the 8th minute. 9 to be added on. The Iranian goalkeeper, Behrenvand, comes as far out of his penalty area as he dares, lumps it forward high and hopeful. Good lead by Walker Zimmerman to clear it away. Hadji Wright falls to the ground but can't control it for the United States of America. Possession is picked up by Jalali on the left-hand side. Doesn't fancy pumping it in. Gives it back to the defender, Hosseini. Now he goes long. Then it's a flicked-on header one. Marouane comes out. Ball through his legs and it's cleared away by Zimmerman. That was so close for Iran. The goalkeeper was nutmegged, but the ball had no pace and it couldn't carry over the goal line. America regained possession and it's cleared away by Weston McKennie. And this is absolutely frantic now. We're about to go into the 9th minute. The Iranians are all making the rectangular gesture and they want the officials to look at this and they want it to go to VAR. What do they think they've seen? The ball was flicked on, out came the goalkeeper, not made through his... I think they're trying to say that goalkeeper Matt Ryan commits a foul on poor Ali Gadi, who's coming in, but I don't think... I think he's fallen his feet, he's already lost his balance, he's trying to collide into the goalkeeper. I'd be surprised if the video assistant referee wants to come and deem that to be a foul. The protests are continuing. It was Taremi who was the player who collided with the goalkeeper, and he's now leading right up into the goalkeeper's face. The case for the prosecution here to say that this might be a penalty. Could it be that Carter Vickers was pulling back his shoulder? If there is a touch, it's only a glancing one. The arm of the goalkeeper is on the defender is on the attacker's shoulder. But I don't, yes, the play ball is back in play. There is no further review from the video assistant referee, who has looked at it, but Dean, there is no case to answer. We're now into the 10th minute of stoppages. The ball is cleared away at the back for the United States of America by Weston McKennie. Now, Iran have pushed everyone forward in the thin at the back as Aronson rolls it in front of Wright. This could settle it, but he's exhausted, Wright, and he falls over like a man with no energy left, and his terrible cross is picked up by the goalkeeper, and Behrenvand pump it down. Iran need one goal or they're out. USA hold on to this, and they're through, along with England, who've beaten Wales by 3-0. This is 5 Live and BBC Sounds of the World Cup. We're into the 11th minute of stoppage time. Iran 0, USA 1. The Iranians pump it into the penalty area. Walker Zimmerman is back. He heads it away and the full-time whistle blows and both players fall to the ground like boxers at the end of 15 grueling rounds. There's barely a smile of celebration from the Americans on the pitch because they've given it everything. The energy comes from the substitutes and the backroom staff who've run on from the technical area. The Iranians are down and out. In truth, they weren't good enough today. They didn't muster the attempts on target that might have troubled Matt Turner. But it is the United States who, unbeaten in the group, will make their way now into the last 16 of the World Cup. They gain revenge for 1998 when in Lyon the Americans were beaten by Iran. Iran's controversial World Cup is over, and it'll be interesting to see what stories will follow about homecomings from their players. But here and now, from a footballing point of view, this is USA's day. They have beaten Iran and they go through to the last 16. Iran 0, USA 1. Mark.
That was breathless, Connor. Breathless.
Breathing through the ears.
Mike and Richards, we've got it on in a monitor in the stadium where we are, where England are beating Wales by 3-0. I don't think I've ever seen a game with qualification on the line, so where one team is going to celebrate and one team is going to lose, where both sets of players just fall to their knees at the end because they're exhausted.
Absolutely brilliant scenes there. The way there's, I think it was Musa who was in picture at the time. It's been brilliant. He was brilliant against England again. But what a result for USA. They came here. A lot of people didn't give them a chance. But to get that win when it mattered the most, absolutely outstanding from USA.
Chances right at the end for Iran. There were claims for penalties as well. But the USA hold on. They finished second in the group. England have topped the group after beating Wales by 3-0. Iran finished third. Wales are bottom. England will now meet Senegal in the last 16. They beat Ecuador earlier today by 2-1.